I was like, I think I can split these up and put Ren right in the middle and do two Pyra and two Jacob.
Single guy.
Well, I suppose I have to get into roll 20.
That would probably be advised.
Sorry, I just woke up, yo.
No worries. I did the same about like a half hour ago, and I was sitting there coughing up, and it just felt like somebody put sandpaper down the back of my throat. So I chugged down some Theraflu, and I'm here for the game.
Shit, he found out I put sandpaper down his throat.
I wouldn't be surprised, that Epi guy.
We are back. Hi, everybody.
Hi, Seb.
At least one of you cares.
The rest of your turn. Hi.
No. So.
If I'm muted.
All right, starting at the top. Epi, who are you playing as the seventh character?
Oh, I'm going. I'll go as Rap.
No, you know what? Actually, sorry, we have six, so no. You're going to help me.
Oh, Lord.
No,
I'm going to run this. This is fine. You can make sure and go get some energy drinks so you can stay up all night.
Ooh, that might be an idea.
Get 3 hours. So, Fallen, who are you playing today?
I am going to bring in for the 10-1 slot, Pyra.
Pyra? You think this adventure's only going to take 3 hours? Only 3 hours? Really?
God. Well, I'm saying for the slot. I'm not saying it's not going to extend.
So, who is Pyra? We haven't seen Pyra in a bit.
Pyra is a 14-year-old wood elven paladin cleric of the god Torm. She was raised in a temple after her parents dropped her off, thinking that she had to possibly be possessed by a demon because of her divine sense.
Okay.
So she started her studies in the temple because they were the only ones that could actually see that there was more value to her than the potential of the demon entities that her parents were imagining, and told the priest that they could go ahead and kill their daughter.
That's definitely one way to go about it.
Yep.
So, next up, we have Firefly.
Hello.
Who are you playing today's one shot?
I'll bring Ileana.
Ileana back on the team. Sticks her hand in the middle. She's like, I'm team captain. Peppers. Peppers, are you there? If you're talking, you're muted. Yaha falls down the stairs. Caitlin, hi.
Hi.
Who are you playing this morning?
I'm going to be playing our lovely, chipper, happy-go-lucky, perpetually optimistic human cleric, Freya.
No. Anyone but her. Anyone
The
but
fact
her.
That you actually have me this chipper in the morning after I've just woken up is a feat. So, you know, good going,
sir. Damn it, did you cast Divine Invention again?
Me? No.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Lies. So
only a couple of days, like only 2 days ago.
In the back, completely covered in camo black, who are you playing?
I quite like to swap out to Sindel, but I am playing Kimmel Malbec, who is the apparently emo boy band rogue knight that hangs around the Malbec Manor and apparently stalks Sindel, according to the tea lady.
I mean, the tea lady did give you good tea.
Sorry,
I said the tea lady did give you good tea, so I mean,
she did.
Could she really be wrong?
She's one of Sindel's favorite people now.
Okay. And Peppers, are you back? Again, if you're talking, you're muted. Okay.
DM.
So, all of you show up together. In the Fearless Wolf, Sefri kind of...
Oh, I see how this goes.
Oh, sorry, I thought you were playing Tassar, so I didn't need to talk to you.
Oh!
Hi, Fishy! How are you?
Hello, I'm good.
Since you're playing a visible character today, who is that character? And
it's Tenon. He is a moon elf monk. He is not having a great week, so hitting things will be really good. He will enjoy it, and he will hit things.
But will he actually hit them?
Well, if Roll 20 doesn't hate me, then yes.
I have faith that Tenon will hit the things.
You're messed up now because she has faith. That's one of the signs of the apocalypse, so...
Yeah, that's it. We're done.
And it's over. So, you, as tight as you exit your house, you see your wife come waddling back in, plate full of food, you know, two large backpacks worth of pastries, even though there's, like, a pastry delivery that you saw arrive this morning.
No, she's borrowed his bag of holding and filled them all in there.
Oh, Lord.
You know, it's a really good thing that stuff doesn't get stuck together in the bag of holding, because he has his, like, old book in there, the old bunk book, and if you got pastry all over that, that would be...
Roll me a D100.
Oh, no. Why are you ruining my book?
I didn't say I was ruining your book. Let's roll me a D100, Sindel.
Oh, I do.
And, you know, her as well.
Okay.
See if the book and any of the pastries come close together.
I got an 82.
On an 82, it's completely smushed in the book. No, but, like, there's this one little drop of... You're not sure if it's raspberry jam or whatever. It just gets on, like, one of the two tips of the corner pages. Just enough where they stick a little bit, but nothing ever is ruined. But every time you go there, you just have to tug a little bit extra, and you're like, swear? And you have to go through your whole, like, monk training to calm yourself back down.
She shrugs. Eh, big dream, man.
The book's even more effective in teaching you now.
Yeah, it is.
It now comes with a living example. Your wife. So, you guys eventually may all make your way to the wolf. As Ilyana's sitting there with, like, she's taken up one of the wall... she's asked one at Carrick for one of the walls, and she has, like, all these notes pinned all over. She's like... This is our day. And there's strings, like, lining them to next to each other. And, like, question marks. And she's just looking at it. So, yeah, you turn around and apparently a party has formed right behind you.
Oh, sorry. Sorry for disappearing.
Excellent.
Yaha continues to fall down the stairs and then lands with the party.
Yay.
You can take, take 9 points of fall damage as you hit your head repeatedly on every stair on the way down.
I'm ready. That's all I say. As I just, you know, rub dirt on my head.
Okay. So, Ilyana, you look. You have your party assembled around you.
Excellent. How do you guys feel about tea?
I love tea. Where does it come from? Where's the shipment coming from? How expensive are we talking?
I love tea. It's my favorite letter.
Freya leans over, waves at Brenny. Hello, Brenny.
Oh, you guys are actually in the wolf right now.
Oh, we're in the wolf.
Yeah, you got Ileana has made a situation room for all the parties for the rest of the day.
I see.
A situation room.
Yep.
Freya actually says, well, if it's to help out Brenny, then yes, I will help.
There's a crudely drawn stick figure of Brenny that Ileana has made.
Did I have to be here?
She also would have told Kimmel that the sleeping potion was administered to Ace. Already. So.
Makes a note to go and thank Griff. And clap him on the back later.
Well, Brinny had a shipment of tea gone missing. And it needs to be delivered. There's also missing merchants, and they didn't know much about it other than something large came through the forest as the trees moved. We can go and try and see if we can find it. Or the merchants, or at least figure out what happened. What do you say?
Yes, I'd be happy to come and help.
Any local threats?
We can't have tea going missing. I mean, that's just wrong.
That's half of my tea. Favorite beverages. Already gone.
Right.
Where are we going?
Well, we could go talk to Brinny again, but,
No, thank you.
Okay. So you guys start walking out the northern gate, and none of you actually know where you're heading.
We said we'd talk to Brinny?
I only heard Pepper say no, so I didn't hear anyone say yes.
I said no, thank you.
I said I'd like to talk to her.
Okay, so Yaha plays with dirt on her head, while the rest of you go talk to Brenny.
Oh, no, I'm now brushing it out of my hair, but you know.
Okay. As you guys arrive, you know, the store's now open. There's a couple customers in line as she looks, and she waves to those of you that she knows, and nods to the rest. And, you know, it takes a couple minutes before, you know, the customers kind of walk off to their... Ileana, you're back so soon. Hello, Tenon. Hello, Freya. Hello, the other two.
Hi, Brenny.
Pyra waves excitedly, sort of like Sefri does to some people.
She, like, leans over and, like, motions for Tenon to come close. And, like, covers her mouth and whispers to Tenon, That guy that I think stalking your wife's right there. Should we call the guard?
What? What guy?
She points right at Kimmel.
That's her
brother. Raises an eyebrow.
Alright, he's still kind of creepy though.
I know, but he's not that bad.
Okay, I'll trust you on this one.
You know I can hear you, right?
She goes,
I'm stood right here.
I look around, I can't see it.
We came to get some more information about the tea shipment that went missing, to see if we could go help.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, so it's about 4 hours away. Last we knew, they were following the road. There's kind of a small cliffside that leads down to a smaller other kind of ravine. That's as far as anyone ever got, was the cliffside. It's a small kind of grove, very beautiful, but outside of that, that's where the trail of the stuff that was missing is gone. And she pulls out a small, like, kind of map. And shows it to you guys so that you can figure out where you're going. Like, she shows you the trade routes of where exactly the caravan was going when it was hit. That's really all I can know. So then I guess we would be talking payment, right? For the five of you, then.
I believe it's... Is Yaha there?
No. Yaha did not want to go.
No, I didn't want to go to Brynja's house.
Brynja's, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I am waiting for them a block away, probably.
Okay.
It's six, actually, but one of our members, the party, decided that they had something else that they needed to do while we talked, I believe.
Okay. I can offer you... She looks at the invoice, she looks at this. I can offer you each about 1,200 gold. If the shipment comes back.
Pyro's eyes go wide. Broad red eyes.
We will do our best. I think that's fair.
Varel, please be safe.
Thank you. We'll try to be.
Okay, so you guys have now the direction.
Yeah, thanks.
The location. She no longer thinks Kimmel's a stalker, just kind of creepy.
Just creepy. Fair enough.
As you head out, you know, at the end of the street, Yaha's trying to terribly hide from the halfling who runs a tea shop. So you guys make your way out of the northern gates. That being said, we're going to do a travel mechanic. Because why not?
Travel mechanics.
So we're gonna get on the road to this location. You're gonna tell me a story relating it to a skill check you rolled that cannot be rolled by anyone else. And you're gonna either pass or fail. Pass, everyone passes, really good things happen. And Brynja isn't creepy, not Brynja. It's Brenny. That is a whole different person, Nidar. So, Pyrrha, we're on the trail to find some tea. Wait, what happens? How do you combat it?
Along the path forward, Pyrrha ends up going forward as a group of travelers coming from the other direction after all the devastation and everything that's ended up happening within Penrith come forward. So seeing the emblem of Torm on her shield, they're drawn towards her, and she makes an effort to lead them in a prayer to try to raise their spirits once more.
Okay. So roll me that religion. 18. The prayer goes pretty well. You know, they definitely look, and everyone takes the moment. And they look, and they all kind of nod to you, and are very thankful as they look to the group, and then they make their way on. Morning, yeah, it is still morning. We don't know how good it is. I woke up way too early for the 24-hour stream, so yeah, it's gonna be pushing it hard. So they keep going on as we then go to Sephiri.
Can you actually go to the next person? Because my roll 20 is going, nope.
So as Sephiri is walking forward, there is a loading screen. She needs to roll me a roll 20 connection first. Ileana, what problem do you guys encounter and how do you deal with it?
I would say that in their travels, they come across a seller of potions, and some of his cart has gotten overturned, and his vials have gotten mixed up. And
he must be part of the Redenbacher dynasty then, if something bad's happened to him. But continue.
Oh yeah. And she's going to help him try and, I think, use investigation to try and help sort out his potions.
Okay, so I'll allow it. Yeah, in no time. You're sitting there talking to him, not even looking, just knowing which one's what, and doing it properly. He thanks you, and you know what? He gives each of you one potion of healing. Just a basic potion.
Thank you.
That's still more than nothing.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
that is,
you.
That is definitely some donation money taken that I've given back in random, you know, gives. So, Yaha, what problem do you encounter? And how do you solve it with a skill check?
Okay.
And if you go crazy here, there's one point out. You go super crazy here, Peppers, and you fail, there'll be consequences.
Oh, okay. I drop a coin in... Wait, we're on a wagon, right?
You're walking.
Oh, we're walking. I drop a coin and in a bunch of rubble, like a gold coin, and then I try to do an investigation on it.
Investigation was already used. You can't use investigation.
Darn. Okay, so...
And you may now take down one gold coin after sheet.
No! That did happen.
This is what happens for not paying attention.
All right. Well, I lost a gold coin. Oh, well.
Are you still going to come up with something?
Could I roll perception on it then?
Nope. You can come up with a new one now.
Okay. I try to look at the local area and see the history because I'm not familiar with the area.
Sure. Roll me a history.
18?
Yeah, it's going to be hard. You look at the local area, and you walk right into, and you like, there's a sign that says historical area of Plot Train. You're not very familiar with the Plot Train, or why this would be of historical significance.
I hide behind Ileana because I don't know this area very well.
Okay. Tenon. Hello.
I think so. They're coming across, we're walking on the path, and there is like a big hole in the road. It'd be really hard to get around. So Ten is going to take his plus one net. And he is going to get up on one side and then do some acrobatics to get over the hole and pin it down on the other side so everybody else can get across.
Okay.
And not do very well.
No, it does not.
Bad roll.
So, Tenon attempts it in the... you don't know if it's everything else on your mind or whatever... goes to flip over it and lands on his face. Brushes himself off. Everyone else walks around. As we go to Kibble. Ghost?
Huggles?
Ah, sorry, mine's cutting out. Sorry, Peppers, but Yaha is inevitably talking about her crossbows. Repeatedly. So Kimmel will take a couple of steps off, like, point to something. Yaha, over there! And then he's gonna sneak off and walk alongside the party, but in the woods, where Yaha can't see him.
Okay.
Okay. Who is that guy again? Oh yeah, he was the cute one. That's Sindel's brother. Okay, I don't care.
So on a 30, yeah, you're significantly hidden from Yaha.
Who is Kimmel again?
Oh no! No, Yaha. I need you to roll... Mm-hmm. Actually, Kimmel, I need you to roll me a charisma check.
Oh god.
What?
Yeah, I need you to roll me a fangirl roll. So we have a flat d20 for fangirl.
Mm-hmm. 13.
Yeah, even though his charisma's not the greatest, he's pretty cool. He's got that air of mystery. And Yaha, you are definitely the fan of the emo boy band look. Like, you get that he was kind of being really rude here. in what he tried to do. However, you're like, he's soft on the inside. And he's so talented. Look at how well he stealthed away.
Kimmel is really nice.
He 10 out of 10. Would want an autograph.
10 out of 10. When he does reveal himself, you might squee a little bit. So, enjoy fangirling for the rest of the session for Kimmel. You brought this upon yourself, Huggles.
No, I did. I know.
Freya!
I think I might actually have a connection now. The gods have seen fit to grant me a connection with the Roll 20.
We have.
Okay, so as they're walking along, as you know, as Clerica Vil made her do, eventually she comes across, of course, people that are not financially in a really good position, but one of them is actually very very hurt, you know, farming accident. They were
so mirth,
you know, trying to mirth. They were trying to, you know, start to prepare the fields and stuff like that, mm-hmm. In preparation for spring. And, you know, they were plowing, and they came across, of course, you know, a rock. And when one of them actually reached down to go and grab the rock, they accidentally cut themselves on, you know, like on the sharp piece of metal from the plow, and guy is bleeding pretty badly, but I mean they've got it mostly under control. Freya, of course, you know, awkwardly rushes over, trying not to trip, and we'll do a medicine check to see if she can't actually make sure that it's bandaged properly, because she does have a healer's kit with her.
Okay, give me a medicine check. Yeah, definitely take care of the wound. As you do, you get them all bandaged, and Frey is a talkative lass. You kind of tell him where you're going, because they ask, and he tells you of an easier route to kind of get down the cliffside. So, as you would have been starting there, you're going to start over here instead. So I'm going to move all you.
Alternate paths.
Oh, yes. You don't have to climb down the cliffside with some of you in heavy armor.
Oh, why can't I see?
Because I just transferred maps. So instead of trying to climb down the cliffside over there, you guys kind of find your way into the grove as you...
Kimmel looks a little sad, although none of you can see it because he didn't get to use his climbs kit again.
There.
Not actually turn order.
I was about to say, what?
Yes. The farmer's actually a villain. And he sent you into a trap. So you guys kind of come on this nice little path as you guys are in control of where you go now.
This is the prettiest trap I've ever seen.
I feel like Kimmel is more here.
Kimmel, give me an acrobatics check. Because you would have had to go down without to maintain your way down the path. Yeah, you're fine. You can still be there. I'm saying I wanted to see if Yaha had to squee yet. So.
What?
You think I'm joking? It's canon.
Oh, great.
If it happens. So, you guys are in charge of it.
Well, I can go near the front.
I want to be like Kimmel someday.
That'll work.
Fast. I know Kimmel's around here somewhere, so...
I'm sure he's watching over us very, very kindly.
Alright, well, we should probably try and keep it down. Shipments are disappearing. There's a reason, so let's try and be quiet. Have a look around. Yes. Unless anybody has any better ideas.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to hide in a tree too.
Okay.
Which tree are you trying to hide in?
Not Kaimo's tree. Because no, I can't find Kaimo.
There's a green one to your left, and then there's one down further. Which one are you trying to climb in?
The one to my left, or maybe just some bushes.
Give me an athletics.
Crap, that's not the one I was trying to do. Sorry. Acrobatics?
No, athletics.
Oh, athletics. Athletics, okay. Oh, three.
Yeah, hug is currently hugging the tree as you guys move forward.
This is just fine.
Kimmel's gonna stealth as he moves down. So.
Sephiri will kind of look at Yaha and go, well, you know, I do maintain that hug therapy is actually quite beneficial to the human soul. I haven't actually studied the effects yet of hugging a tree in relation to hug therapy. So thank you very much, Yaha.
Pyra heads down towards the flowers, picks one individual small flower that doesn't look like it would end up hurting the overall look of the garden, and then brings it to Sephiri and offers it out.
She goes, oh, thank you, Pyra.
As everyone is moving forward, you swear the tree hugs you back.
Yay! Something loves me!
Tenon's just gonna peek around this tree. Perception check.
So 23. You're not noticing. I mean, there's small critters about and stuff like that, but mm-hmm. Yeah, don't really see much right now. I mean, we're going down like a hidden path. Out. You didn't go down the route that you think that whatever the creatures were would take. You went mm-hmm. down like this old path that the farmer knew about. From living there all his life.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's... Yeah, we're...
It saved you having to potentially fall and hurt yourselves.
Not that Tenon would, but...
Especially, yeah.
There we go.
Alright, he's just gonna slowly move forward.
Oh no, yeah. The tree's still hugging him.
Oh, okay.
Tree's not letting go.
I pat it on its back. I spray for a little bit of help here.
What is happening? What
the
doing?
Tree is hugging me back.
Okay,
I just have Anna's hag flashbacks now.
Okay, so she kind of comes over to the tree, you know, and just like she did with Kiki, she'll be like, "Oh, hi there, tree. You're so big and strong with your bark and, you know, providing us with shade and comfort. Would you terribly mind releasing my friend Yaha?"
There's so that we can. As you look, there's nothing holding Yaha there.
I think she's supposed to be just saying it to make Yaha feel better.
Okay, I didn't know which one, but I'm just saying. Just so Freya's aware, there's nothing holding Yaha there.
Okay, fair enough. She'll keep going and be like, okay, you know, all right, tree, it's okay. You can let go of Yaha. She knows very much that you love her, and she obviously very much loves you. And then she'll turn to Yaha and say, Yaha, even nature itself loves you. You can let go of the tree and walk knowing that you are loved by even nature itself.
I feel at the end and I just let go.
You're still hugging the tree.
What?
Ted is gonna have a look in this log.
Okay.
Am I stuck to it?
See if there's anything.
No, you're being hugged by a tree.
Pyra starts singing the I love you, you love me, Yaha's hugging a great big tree.
Give me 1 second to see what I put in there, Ted.
What's that?
Give me 1 second to see what I put in there.
Okay.
Is there a strength save required?
No.
Yaha? Does Yaha need
You're
a look upside?
Tree?
Roll me a D100, Tenon.
Okay.
Oh, wait. This is a tree, right?
97.
You find something in there. Looks like a rope.
Woohoo! A what?
Looks like a rope.
A rope?
Yeah.
I will carefully pick it up.
As you pull the rope... No, there's no trap there. Would have been a great trap, though, wouldn't it?
It would have been, but now
a bunny rabbit kisses her on the nose.
It's 60 feet of silk rope. It weighs about 3 pounds.
Sweet.
Pretty.
I'm definitely bringing this home to Sindel. I mean, say that?
I would say that...
Awkward.
One would say, Sindel, pregnancy weight, since you're here, and since it was mentioned, how much do you weigh? And what pregnant would baby weight on you?
She wasn't that heavy beforehand.
I know.
Really lift. Genuinely don't know.
Take a guess.
Like, I genuinely, because I don't think I can actually, get the sensible weight for her.
I'd probably put her about 130, 140 with the baby weight.
130? Okay. One could say that it could hold about 200 Sindels.
Awesome.
How heavy is a Sindel? Oh, wait, no, I'm not supposed to ask that.
With babies.
Oh, with babies, with okay.
Twins, yeah. Nice.
I have now put that on single sheet.
Awesome. I am happy.
Give me a free Arcana.
Okay. Okay. 13.
Just makes the DC.
Yes!
This is a rope of climbing.
Nice, sweet!
It can hold up to 3,000 pounds.
What?
Suspended. If you hold one end of the rope and use an action to speak the command word, the rope animates. As a bonus action, you can command the other end to move to a destination that you choose. That end moves 10 feet on your turn, so it will take a couple turns if you're going full length, right?
Mm-hmm.
Until it makes it there to the maximum length, or you tell it to stop. You can also tell the rope to fasten itself securely to an object, or to unfasten itself, knot itself or unknot itself, or to coil itself for carrying. Yeah. The rope has an AC of 20 and 20 hit points, and it regains one hit point every 5 minutes, as long as it at least has one hit point.
That's awesome.
That's going in the bag of holding. We are going to need this. I am glad I found this.
So, as I'm doing that, Camel.
Yeah.
Make me a constitution save, buddy.
Constitution?
Tell me what you roll, because I'm making a sheet for Madfish.
Okay. Come on. Okay. 7?
The flowers are really pretty, Kaimal. And they smell sweet. You just want to jump in the... You just want to jump in the flowers.
Is this Elf Nip?
He does. Tell it, check these out. Jumps in the flowers.
You all watch as Kaimal's rolling around in a bed of flowers.
Does he roll around in them like a cat?
It's like a cat on cat.
Does he try to eat
But he's
them?
So happy. He's laughing. He's just got a big smile on his face. Like, if he's, you know, the hood's down. Like, he's just... He's almost polar opposite Kaimal. When he's actually happy.
Kaimal, I didn't know that you liked flowers so much.
It's amazing.
Tenon's just
check them out.
His ass off.
Okay, she'll do an Arcana check.
Okay, roll me an Arcana. Are you getting close to them, or are you just doing this from a distance?
A distance.
Yeah, you really can't tell anything about them from here.
She'll get closer.
You are pretty far away.
Wait. And she looks at Yaha and is like, stay here.
I don't think I can move.
And goes to Ileana. I will cast Protection from Poison.
Climb on the sky with diamonds? Yes, Dinar, yes. You can guys in Protection from Poison? Is that what
Protection from Poison, yes.
Okay.
Because this is, I mean, while it's very much a very welcome change from Kaimal, it is very much out of the norm for him.
I will have to agree with you there, Zephyr.
I have no idea what you're about.
Kaimal, deep down and deep down in your core, as this is happening, how far can you have to be to cast this? Fred, you're casting it on Kaimal?
No, I'm not. I'm casting it on Ileana.
Okay. I was wondering who you're... it's touch, right?
Yeah. That's okay. Why I'm casting it on Ileana, if she was going to go up there to go and investigate.
Kaimal, deep down inside, do you love Tenon like a brother, right?
Mm-hmm.
You need to profess that love to Tenon right now.
Tenon, my dude. I love you. You're amazing. Like, Sindel doesn't even argue with you. How do you do that? Like...
He's trying. He can barely talk because he's laughing so hard. He's like, I love you too, man. He's just like doubled over.
Kaimal, like your heart grows two sizes when you hear Tenon say he loves you too, man.
Aww. That means so much.
Like, I'm a now couple tears start coming down the sides of Kaimal's cheeks. And Ileana, so do you move up to do another Arcana?
Yeah.
Alright, Constitution save.
Is it, if it's versus a poison
it's
effect,
not a poison,
she'll
but
have
Ileana's
advantage.
Fine. It's not technically a poison, but she's fine anyways, because she rolled like a boss. Tenendip, you're moving up. I also need one from you.
Okay. He would at this point, because he's going to go and try and pull.
Yeah.
Pull him out.
Nope. Yeah, you join Kaimal rolling in the flowers.
Happily.
And even more, like, he's almost like, Tenon's a generally happy individual, right? Like, most times, he's pretty a happy individual. You're surpassing Freya levels of happiness.
Oh, like, no. Turn him off.
As that distance from normal Kimmel to Kimmel right now happens, you go from normal Tenon to, like, Tenon right now levels of happiness in these flowers. As you now start rolling around in the flowers.
But he's more like... I think he would be more in a state of, like... bliss.
Yes. Like, bliss,
like,
and giggles.
That Buddha.
Yeah.
You know, bliss like a cat in the sun.
I asked someone to bring me some of those flowers. I might need them at some point.
Flame strikes. What?
No, I accidentally clicked. I was trying to click the cog next to it.
Damn these happy flowers. Burn!
Like a bit of
we're not allowed to be happy. We're adventurers.
How dare you roll in these flowers? I'm gonna barbecue them and treat them like pot.
So Ileana, they're not magical. Or give me an Arcana. Sorry, I thought you rolled a 21 Arcana. Yeah, they're not magical.
Nature?
Yeah, you can roll a nature if you like. I really want Freya to get close to these. There's something about, you don't know the type of flower they are, but they do, once you come within 5 feet of them, they, like, the pollen itself gets into your nostrils and just just starts releasing things to almost a dangerous degree that make you overly happy. And it takes you from your baseline to this point.
Oh. Oh, goodness. She'll holler back to Freya since she's far away and everyone else to say, like, these flowers have a pollen with them. They make you really happy.
I fail to see how this is a problem.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I might need some of them.
Everybody's on my level.
Ileana, can you bring me some of those?
Tenet looks like he's gonna, at this point, he looks like he's not getting up. He's not going anywhere.
Oh, for goodness. Okay. Yaha.
Tenon, I need you to attempt to make one roll. Tenon, I need you to roll me. You don't have alchemist tools, right?
No.
Just give me a straight wisdom check. You are in a state of blissness.
Of meditate. Oh, shit.
You can't be sure, but some plan that you hatched way back in, like, Lakia days about trying to make some sort of potion that made people happy and put away the bullshit. You look at these flowers and you're like, I found them. I found them.
He's gonna start.
Yeah, man, bro.
He's definitely taken some of these.
I asked Freya to
again,
pull me off of the tree.
Again, I remembered that from all this time. I'm like, I'm putting something in there. You're not going to be able to, like, make a ton, but you'll be able to make a couple doses.
Yeah, well, it's for emergencies. Yep. Save it for emergencies. The chill the fuck out potion.
Yep. With alchemy help, you'll be able to make at least 2 chill the fuck out potions.
Awesome.
But they're still well under the effects of this right now.
Okay, and Yaha's currently stuck to a tree.
I look to Freya and ask her to pull me off.
Okay, Freya will attempt to pull Yaha away from the tree.
Give me opposed athletics, Yaha and Freya. And Yaha, you can use acrobatics or athletics, your higher one.
Oh, okay.
It's technically a grapple. You go to grab her and she somehow wraps herself in some sort of, like, pretzel, and you can't at all budge her.
Join me.
She just looks and goes, please take me off. And she just, you see, like, she's gritting her teeth. She's saying one thing, but she is acting completely different.
Now, Miss Yaha, you have to... Could you please? Obviously, my theories about hug therapy are correct. It is incredibly beneficial, and it has broader-reaching applications, just beyond actually hugging people. Apparently, now you can actually hug trees and receive the same benefits.
This is probably as happy as you ever seen Yaha as well.
Wait.
I wish you'd pet me on my head now.
Can I do... Oh, like, I want to do a medicine check to see if...
Sure.
If...
Medically,
oh,
she's fine.
Oh, yeah, but she's obviously under the influence of something.
Too much hugs, that's what.
Or she's just finally snapped mentally.
Oh, if I snap mentally, I'm going to tell Freya I'm a princess.
Ileana will walk up over to see what's taken. What's with Yaha?
Yaha is force-hugging a tree.
I'm sorry. I'm having difficulty getting this Yaha to unhook herself from this tree. If I could actually get your assistance in removing her from this tree, that would be fantastic, Ileana.
Miss Freya, I have a lot of respect for you. Please call me Lady Yaha.
Are you okay, Yaha?
I don't know. I wish this tree will pet me instead of hug me.
You feel like the tree begins to pet you.
Ah, much better.
You're still pretty attached to the tree.
She's gonna, before she touches, she's gonna do an arcana. It's probably not, nature would probably be a good follow-up after, but...
Okay. Not magical, it's a tree.
As it makes sense.
Seems to be a normal tree.
Huh. Can she... She's... Yaha?
Yes?
Why haven't you let go of the tree?
Because it's holding me. And it's being really nice to me. Nicer than anyone has ever been to me in my entire life, I think. I feel happy now. Oh. But I don't want to be here.
Freya looks incredibly perplexed at Ileana and is like, I...
Pyrrha. You trip and fall on the flowers in front of you. They're just regular flowers, though.
Can... When I look at Yaha, she has her hands wrapped around the tree.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, as much as they can go around the tree. I mean, she can't get all the way around it.
Right. By now, I'm crying tears of joy. I asked the tree if it wants to be a eunuch.
Doesn't understand.
Can
you live?
She will look to the tree. And she's gonna ask if it can let Yaha go.
Okay, you look to the tree, you ask. There's no response, it's a tree.
I tell the tree, you should probably save some of this for Zulon, because she could use more hugs than I can, probably.
Again, it's a tree.
Do I know it's a tree?
Yaha, I understand that you're having a good time with the tree, but we do need to find the tea shipment and the missing merchants, which they might have found a tree too, or the flowers, and that's why they're gone.
Could I make a wisdom save against this tree?
No.
I really want to go with you guys, but I don't know why, but this tree is hugging me. I don't want to be alone, because... When I'm alone, bad things happen.
It's a tree.
Well, we can try and pull you off the tree again.
Please do.
Pyrrha slowly gets up and moves forward towards Yaha and tries to pull Yaha away from...
Okay, so you make me an athletics. Peppers make me another acrobatics.
There you go, Pyrrha.
Good job,
Chris. Oh, 13!
You successfully remove Yaha from the tree.
Thank you, Pyrrha. I'm eternally in your favor. I whisper in her ear, I'm a princess.
Pyrrha just slowly blinks, not quite understanding, and then touches the circlet that she got from the pear. She's like, me too.
You feel lonely all of a sudden. Yeah?
I hug Ileana.
Ileana hugs Yaha back?
I love you, Sister Ileana.
As you try to let go, you seem stuck to Ileana.
Does
he's looking at his hands.
Yaha have, covered like, in something?
Does Ileana have what? Oh. Huh.
Freya sort of sighs and kind of smiles and is like, oh, classic Yaha. Pyrrha, we need your help again to separate these two. I mean, like, as I've said, I know the benefits of hug therapy are untold in number, but unfortunately, I believe Yaha is actually covered in sap, and this is not really beneficial to us right now. Would you mind horribly helping? I'll pull one, you pull the other.
Pyra moves forward towards Yaha again, reaching out to grasp the back of Yaha's collar and goes to try to pull.
There's no contestant here. Yeah, you pull her off.
Thank you.
Yaha, don't hug anything else, please.
You still feel incredibly lonely, Yaha. There's almost like a longing.
I miss Pyra. Your eyes.
Pyra points a finger at Yaha and says, "You hug me, and I'm gonna."
I miss her eyes too.
Zephyr looks horribly uncomfortable and is like, "Okay, so tea. We have tea. We have a shipment of tea we have to go find, and some merchants."
Pyra makes her way back down towards the log.
First, we have to go help Tinnin and Kaimal. They're currently rolling around in the happy flowers.
Could you guys save me some of those flowers?
Yeah, I'm feeling really bad.
Oh crap! Wait, where?
You're right there. You getting in there?
I know, I was right here. No, I didn't.
I thought you wanted the flowers. Don't you want them?
No, I asked them if they could give me some flowers when they're out.
That's not gonna help you.
Oh no.
We're not sharing our flowers.
And it's a constitution.
Oh no, no, hold on a second. Yeah, you see Kimmel.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no.
You squee and try and get close to him. Please make a constitution save.
Okay.
The flowers do not affect you. You are not happy. Except for the fact that you see Kimmel.
Can you pet my head?
Do you have more flowers?
I mean, you're surrounded by them. I don't see what's so special about these flowers.
Oh, they're awesome. Tenen!
Do I feel less lonely?
No.
Tenen's gonna hug Kaimal.
Kaimal hugs Tenen back.
Pyra takes out of her priest pack one of the sticks of incense and carefully lights it.
Okay.
Before she'll start to move closer towards Tenen and Kaimal.
Okay. I'm gonna say that you can make a constitution save.
What was that you cut out?
Con save.
No.
Yeah, even with advantage. Drops the incense, dives into the flowers.
Whee! Good enough.
Crawling in my skin.
You need to make another con save, Ileana, as you approach the flowers.
Me?
Who does?
Ileana. She left the area and then came back.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
She's like, I'm not even mad if I get... Dives into the flowers.
Save us, everyone.
You are the only hope.
Okay, she is going to put... Because, obviously... somebody had actually mentioned something about the pollen, so she is actually going to put something over her mouth and nose, like a cloth or something. She's got her scarf that Tassar had knitted her for the Lunar Festival, so she will make sure that it is covering her mouth and nose. I am actually also going to cast as a cantrip. I will cast resistance on myself.
Okay.
So, just so you have it.
Yep.
Just in case. Now, obviously, all of these folks are suffering from the effects of something. I'm just trying to figure out if a lesser restoration or if I have to do dispel magic.
You would get that.
Ileana would tell you that they're not magic.
Based on what Ileana knew,
it's natural.
If you got them out of the area, the effects would. They would be happy.
Sorry,
based on what Ileana told you, you'd be able to guess. If you get them away from the flowers and just held on to them for a moment or two, that the effects would quickly end.
Okay. Then I will make the attempt to grab. Let's go for Tenon first.
Okay, so Severin moves. Okay.
Severin moves down. Do you mind if I braid your hair?
Hey, I was moving me. There all we right. go.
Tenon, you want to pretty much stay put, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so it will be contested. Good morning.
I mean,
Dorian currency.
I can't. I don't know if I can intentionally not make it that hard, but
no, it's okay. It's kind of just natural reaction.
Yeah. Okay. So. Hey, maybe you'll actually be able to. For once, a good roll might work for me.
So Shepard basically pulls Tenon over here. It holds on to him for a minute, like a few seconds. Tenon, you feel the it just leave. You're left at a little bit of low for a few seconds, but then it balances out.
He's been here before. He knows how to roll.
Yeah, you're gonna try and grab someone.
I'm going to try to, no, I can't. I have sap on me.
You're gonna make Sephiroth try and grab all of them.
I think it's...
Okay, fine. I'll try to help. But then I'll be stuck to Kaimil. So, you know.
Yeah, grab Kaimil.
So it's a strength? Or athletics?
Athletics.
Oh, great. My weakness. Gym class.
18. Kaimil.
Can I dodge him?
You can roll athletics.
I am a princess, first off. I am a girl.
If you want to use acrobatics, you can.
I'm going to dodge out of the way.
He just rolls as you fall into the flowers.
Does he roll towards me?
You can make an attempt.
I will make the attempt.
He's rolling around, back and forth, laughing. Yeah.
Nope. I'm staying put.
Actually, I kind of like it in this way.
Look at it. Put it in your pack.
I feel really connected to Kaimo right now. I could call him my friend now.
That's great. You can feel connected enough with him to get him out of the flowers.
I tried. <No! laughs> I tried my best.
Is Ileana also affected?
Yeah.
Okay, then I will make the attempt to pull out Ileana.
Can I feel this?
You have to roll it.
Okay. It's not going to be hard. Athletics.
You grab onto her, she's like, no!
I will make the attempt to go for Kimmel then. And I will go back and forth until I grab someone.
Tenon, are you going to wrap your face up and go help?
I'm not even going to bother.
Okay, there. Phone.
Oh!
Yes, I'm going to...
Oh!
Oh! Yeah, no, this one, the tie goes to the person not affected. Kimmel, you are grabbed by the ear.
Ow!
As you are pulled motherly like out and put in time out over there.
Ileana
will wait for Kaimil.
Bye!
Alright, Tenon will try. Who's left?
Pyrrha and Ileana. So, yeah, are you going for Pyrrha? Right.
Is she a paladin?
You don't know. Yes. What does it matter?
Alright.
Okay, fine. Could I use acrobatics to pull her out?
No, it's going to be athletics. Ileana.
Oh, athletics, okay.
Against Ileana? Ileana!
That's not bad.
Ileana's not with Pyrrha. Yep, okay, so Pyrrha, you hear thud thud, and now you're bonded to Yaha as she pulls you out and is stuck to you.
We're sisters forever! No, I won't feel so
every
lonely.
Time. Every time someone tries to pull her out, she just grabs another flower and puts it
in her hair. Like she's making a flower crown.
We'll try again. Grab Ileana.
Yeah.
All right.
Pirate did say that if Yaha tugged for Pyra and everything that she would hit. So it would be a 1d1?
Not right now. We're okay. Going to push this out.
I was just like, okay, Pyra's going to hit.
You're still pretty happy. You're still pretty happy.
Happiness, so the happiness override. So.
Oh, I'm jealous because I don't get to be happy.
With advantage, damn it.
Nope, but the tie goes to the person not affected. Severi picks Ileana up and brings her out.
Alright, guys. I guess we should stay away from those. Or something.
Ileana will look around at the forest and the flowers. And she'll say, just in general, thank you, whoever did the flowers and the tree for bringing happiness.
Anyone have prestidigitation?
No.
By the way, Yaha is still stuck to Pyra.
Someone use prestidigitation.
I will make the attempt to grab Yaha and pull her off Pyra and go, I'm sorry. I know it's almost like pulling a band-aid off.
Yeah.
I only cause more damage. Yeah, I cry though.
At first, you pull Sepri. You pull both of them up off the ground, and you're like, wait a second. You put your foot against Pyra's, like, you were in plate, right?
Pyra? She's in scale mail.
Scale mail. Put a foot against the scale mail, and you're like, there's the suction cup thud as you pull her off. And Yaha still, hands still covered in sap. Looks.
I was imagining it sounding like Velcro. I like the pop better, though.
I have a water skin. Okay. Can I, at the very least, attempt to get some of the sap off of Yaha by washing, dousing her a little bit with water? See if that helps.
Alright.
Yep, you pour water over the hands, it really doesn't seem to move the sap.
It doesn't seem to be helping?
Nope.
Can I do a nature check on the set?
Sure. No, but anyone else like to make that a nature check?
Pyra will go ahead and make a nature check.
Or would you like to guidance? Oh, never mind.
Oh, Pyra, no!
Not Pyra.
Sephir, you want to guidance me? I'll try.
Please don't lick me.
I'm not very good at it, but I'll try.
Sure.
Okay. Nope.
Kaibul or Sephir?
Everybody gets a guidance.
You get a guidance. You get a guidance.
A guidance.
Everybody gets a guidance.
Oh,
yours is wisdom based, correct?
You can use wisdom, yes. On nature.
It's either nature. It's either intelligence or wisdom for nature.
Whatever you choose as a player.
So Firefly, add 1d4.
Okay.
On a 14, no.
She'll take a, can she use, Ileana use Mage Hand and scoop a little bit of the sap in a potion bottle?
You can probably get a little bit, but not much. It's
That's
really
okay.
Pretty much adhered to Yaha.
Yeah, super sticky. That's okay. Just so she has a sample, because she's going to bring it back to the druids.
I'm sorry I got all of you in such a sticky situation.
Kimmel contemplates stabbing Yaha just for that alone.
Alright.
The fridge rolls and kind of, bounces back and forth on her feet. You made a pun! Oh, Yaha, you're so very punny.
Nice God. Dad joke there, Sephri.
Okay.
Can I make a perception check to see if I can
sure.
Anything down?
Yeah. You hear water, a little bit of running water to the north.
Water, okay. I will make sure to tell people that.
What's up here?
As you go front that way.
There.
Yep, you see a log and some water.
Okay. Look in the log!
Oh boy, a log!
Okay, Ileana will go and look in the log.
It's big, it's heavy.
heavy it's wood.
It's log, it's log.
It's better than bad, it's good.
Roll me D100.
Okay. If only that was divine intervention.
You find a small vial with red liquid in it.
Ooh.
Poison.
Do an arcana on it.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, I was making notes. I'd like to do an arcana on it.
Okay. It's not magic.
Oh, nature.
Roll me a nature. It is a potion of greater healing, but it is done through natural ingredients. Therefore, it is not magical.
Ooh, cool.
So it would work in an anti-magic field.
Oh, nice.
Same where like when Perrin or Crystal awesome. Were to make one with using herbalism, they're not magical. If you buy them from Merlin, they're magical.
I see.
Cross-crafting. You also see something in the water, Ileana, from where you are.
Oh! What?
You can't quite tell from where you are.
There's something in the water.
15 feet away.
She's gonna call back to the party and say, I found something in the water.
Okay.
Is it my happiness?
I don't think your happiness is tangible.
Can I do a perception check?
You can.
Ileana, I'm gonna take a level 2.
Yes.
It seems to be this like silverish shining thing at the bottom of the water. Looks like
silver shiny thing.
It looks about the size of like a not a half dollar, but a, like two half dollars together. The best way I can describe it.
He's like, Ileana, can you do the hand thing? And there's a shiny thing right there. Do the hand
thing. Okay. She's gonna do the hand thing.
He means mage hand.
I know.
Oh, not pulling off your thumb.
You bring the mage hand down in as it kind of like scoops. You can see some of the dirt and stuff move from the hand going to grab it. Ileana, it doesn't move.
Oh, is it too heavy?
It's not too heavy, but with the rocks and stuff on it, it's too heavy.
Oh, okay. All right. Oh.
Anyone have a rope?
Yes. I do. I also have a magical rope that I can command to go and go in there. Because I don't know why, but I'm paranoid about the water.
I mean, it can't be any Arcana worse than the flowers.
In the water. Arcana in the water?
Yeah.
Roll it.
I just want to see if it's safe.
It's magical, but you can't tell what kind of magic.
It's magical. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what kind, though.
I think this entire place is magic. It's so beautiful. Anybody it made me else? Happy just for 5 seconds.
Arcana? Tenon will command his silk robe to go and...
What do you... I mean, what's the command word?
Oh, that is a good... that's a good question.
Ileana, would you like to give it another Arcana?
Yes.
Roll the Arcana.
Can anybody else do Arcana?
On a 26... what would you like the command word to be? I'll let you set it. What would you like the command word to be? I'll let you set it.
Yeah, I'm thinking of a word.
Okay, you can think of it, but you say the command word as Ileana tells it to you. It goes out, ties around the item, and pulls it out. You see as it comes out, the end of the rope is just almost melted.
Come back.
You see the rope's taken quite a bit of damage, just going in and coming out. But you watch as it starts, as you're checking it over, taking the minute or so, you watch, and now you understand, as you see it start to almost reattach itself and grow back.
Neat.
So don't go in the water. No.
Hmm?
You did get the item.
Don't go in the water.
I did get the item, yes. But the water is not safe.
No.
Okay.
What kind of weird forest is this?
The 26 arcana was for
the rope.
Okay.
To get the command word. Okay. Because he just was able to identify it. So without knowing the command word, it was useless to him.
Okay.
You immediately recognize this tenon without needing to roll religion.
Mm-hmm.
It is a small medallion of Torn.
Torn?
Huh. Pyra's god.
He'll show Pyra.
Torn? As in a god?
Yeah. Yes.
Yes.
Pyra gasps and looks over the medallion carefully.
Give me a religion check, Pyra. At advantage, it is your god. There's something about this medallion, but you can't place it.
Can I take a look? Can Ileana, too?
Prayer, yeah, you can. We'll go prayer first, and then we'll see if we need you.
Ileana. Yeah, religion? No, that makes sense.
Yeah. Just even, though. Not your god. 17. You've seen not this before, but you've seen similar sort of items. It's used in an enchanting process.
Okay, she will relay that to the party.
Huh. Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Well, hang on to that, I guess. Alright, let's keep going. Back down the other way. Unless anybody else has anything else to do.
I feel lonely.
What's in here?
Okay.
Sweet.
It's trees.
Okay. Oh no, trees. Soon.
She will rejoin.
Okay. Let me just add the medallion to Fallen's.
Could I do a perception check to see if there are any squirrels to avoid?
Sure, give me a perception check.
I can't believe it's taking us this long to get through.
Crap. Here it is. Perception. 10?
You don't see anything.
Oh, thank gosh. I just...
But the squirrels have begun to plot against you.
Not my problem yet.
Fluffy creatures do not like people in Penrith because you got the rats against Fritz and you got Yaha and the squirrels.
I don't really call the rats fluffy. To be fair.
I mean, they're rodents.
I used to have a pet rat.
Well, some can be soft, yeah. So.
So, I'm gonna, I guess, do another perception check. Down this area.
And Kim will, I guess, do the same.
Don't see much. See what you see.
Hmm.
Persuasion.
Can I persuade there to be nothing?
You see that there is... Down here is a pretty thick thicket, but there's a very small kind of, like, almost... carved hole that you could probably get in your hands and knees and climb through, as well as most everyone else.
It's a good thing Sindel didn't come. You can climb through that. This is the only path down.
She would cut a path through.
Yeah. Sindel would just make her own path.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Let's
Kimmo, give me a constitution save.
God damn, I found these flowers again, they're amazing.
Yeah.
Oh no.
What?
You watch as Kimmel walks in front and drops to the ground and begins to snore loudly. And as that happens, everyone roll initiative, including Kimmel. He's currently asleep.
Aw, he looks so cute when he's asleep.
Well, it's not magic. Must be.
And look at that, and he rolled a nat 20.
Oh, Kimmel.
Even asleep, he's still ready.
Especially asleep, he's still ready.
That's true.
One eye up.
Say nat 20 their initiative, too.
Aww.
So Kimmel's asleep. These things. I need to see what their movement is. Okay. So from here, I'll put on the maps. This is now their turn. Here, here, and here. These what looks to look, what at first you thought were just like, you know, small briars and such, come to life. So 5, 10. That one gets to there. Let's see, multi attack.
Did they hug me? Is that what hugged me?
Okay.
Oh, they will.
I need to check something very quickly.
It is non-magical sleep. Okay. Which means you are actually, yeah. That's why. Otherwise, I wouldn't have to make a con save. These come up.
Yeah, it's gonna make the first one.
Yep. Let's see. Go ahead. So, Tenon, gonna make two attacks on you.
Okay.
A 21 and a 12.
Miss.
Okay, this one. It's gonna try and hit Kimmel. At advantage because you're prone and unconscious.
2024. Good. I can't use my reactions, I guess. Nope. So, yeah.
So you take 29 damage. Give me another con save as you've been hit. You're still asleep.
Well then.
Lindo, leave me alone.
And you are currently engulfed by the shambling mound.
Well then.
20. This one will double move to get up here. It automatically engulfs. You make saves after that.
Kimmel's gone.
You're engulfed. You're inside of it.
Oh, okay.
They just can't see it. Oh, yeah. Go ahead. You got it?
No, I'm doing maths now.
29.
No, I'm having to do it manually.
I moved the thing so you could get to the token. I was trying to be nice.
No, I literally called my token. Accurate.
Good call, Nidar. I am completely forgot because we were laughing so much. To move the map. There we go. This is why we keep you around, Nidar. Okay. So, we got a Tenon. It's your turn, Tenon.
Okay.
I'm going to cut him up for you now.
Try and work my way toward the one that has Kimmel in it. I will start with green.
Okay. All three will hit.
Right.
19 and 9 is 28. 33, 40 points of damage from Tendon.
Okay. And, yeah, I'll just say to try not to get swallowed.
Okay. Yaha!
Okay, so I pull out my hand crossbows.
Okay.
And now they're stuck to my hands, right?
Yes, they are.
Okay. I'll get to that bridge when I cross it. Okay, so I strike at the one in front of Pyrrha.
Okay. Only a noble's work once.
Huh?
You can only fire a noble's work once.
Really?
The first one hits, yep.
Okay. Then could I use my offhand?
You can use your offhand.
Okay.
So roll damage on the first one and the last one.
Okay.
42. You now have two unloaded crossbows stuck to your hands. And to reload a crossbow, or any item with ammunition, you need a free hand.
Oh. Well then.
Doesn't she have, like, crossbow expert or something?
It doesn't matter. She can't stow a crossbow.
She's got a sticky sap on her hands.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
A player may once have said, I'd never need a melee weapon.
I have a melee weapon. I just didn't think I'd need it now.
And I like to show people that sometimes you need to plan.
Oh, gosh.
That is the end of Yaha's turn. Sabri.
Hi.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Okay. Aside from scolding these shambling hordes,
you wish you brought Andy actually... so she could have blighted them? I know.
No.
Because you do double damage against plants?
Yeah, I know. No, I will actually Sacred Flame the red one.
Okay. Orange does. Oh, yeah? Yeah? I will roll a 19, and with the minus one, I'll fail. That's 14 damage. It burns. It does not look happy.
She will basically also do the... No, you're not supposed to eat that. Spit him back out. You spit him back out right now.
It seems unamused. So, anything else on your turn?
I can't see Kimmel. Nope. So I know he's taken damage, but I have to be able to see him to do healing words. So, other than that, nope, I'm good.
Okay, Pyrrha.
Pyrrha is going to spin her warhammer over the back of her wrist and engage green with two strikes of her warhammer. And as a bonus action, she's going to call spiritual weapon back here and strike at orange with it.
Okay. So give me your two first attacks as I get something for your spiritual weapon. Okay, search Warhammer and you get...
The game?
No, you get like enemies from the game. Both of those will hit with advantage. 25-27. So 10 to the one up here. Okay.
How do you like that? Nat 1 for both of them.
Oh, don't talk to me about nat 1s. I rolled so many nat 1s on damage yesterday. And then spiritual weapon attack, yep. A 17 hits. You also have control of your Warhammer. Okay. Anything else from Pyrrha?
Nope, that's it.
Okay. Ileana.
Do they look intelligent?
I mean, they have some intelligence. They don't look like... They're not, like, NPC intelligent.
Oh, okay. I was good, because as a free action, Ileana was going to ask him why they're attacking us. Just see if they...
They don't speak a language. I'll tell you that.
Okay. Well, she decides not to fireball the forest.
Yeah.
Yeah. That would be bad. And I know it probably won't work because they're plants. But she's gonna try and poison spray the one next to her since it's in range.
Okay. Con saber.
Mm-hmm.
Take 24 points of damage.
Huh.
As it does, they are not immune to poison. It just kind of shrieks back at the poison, and you see it kind of look towards you. Anything else, Ileana? Oh, I do need you to do something for me for the end of your turn. You need to roll me 3d20s.
Oh, that's right, okay.
Keep these down, because if you play your multiple one-shots, those are your daily rolls. 11, nat 20, and 9. Nice.
Good.
You always get a nat 20 in those rolls. At the end of your turn?
Because if I move, I'll provoke an attack of opportunity, I think. I could Misty Step, but then that would leave everybody here with monsters around them.
Okay. Kymel, still asleep inside of it. Unable to breathe, currently. Kymel, Constitution saving throw. As it's crushing you from the outside, you with it inside it. Kaimal, con save, please. Huggles. Okay, you will take some damage here. And another con save against the effect. Take 13 damage and give me another con save. See if you wake up. You wake up. You are blind, restrained, and unable to breathe. That being said, Ileana, Red is going to attack you evenly, twice.
Okay.
24 and 18, because you don't have mage armor up.
Alright.
You hit both times?
Mm-hmm.
So take 26.
Okay.
What was that, Al?
Are you okay?
And you are engulfed.
That's fair.
10 and blue is going to attack you twice with advantage.
Okay.
You're its only target.
Okay.
25 and 24.
Those will both hit.
Take 29 and damage.
Okay. And is that it?
You are engulfed.
Okay.
Pierre, green's gonna attack you twice. Not at advantage, just evenly. A nat 1 and a 22. 22 hit?
22 does hit.
All right, you'll take 12. It's going to hit its buddy for 11. And that will take us to Tenon. Tenon, you're currently blind, restrained inside this thing, and you can't breathe. There's no air.
Okay. Can I... What can I do?
You can try and break the restraint.
Okay. So that would be athletics, or...
Athletics or acrobatics, your choice.
Oh.
Yeah, just really? You can't get your way out as you just feel it tighten up.
It's and plus 10.
I know.
You're kidding me.
I know. I don't want to tell you that the DC is 14, but the DC is 14. So, you just can't get out this turn. You have no movement, okay. No bonus, so. Yaha!
Okay.
Could I roll strength to get rid of these crossbows?
How are you going to do that? Both your hands are occupied.
Oh, great. Crap. I wish I used my knife instead. Oh well. I'm going to melee it with my hands and...
Roll me strength checks. As you move up. Okay. To, which one are you going for? Red or green? Alright, move up. You'll move up. And you try and hit it.
Strength?
Yep.
Okay. You said strength check?
Yep, because you're not proficient.
Oh, great.
And you can... How many attacks do you have? You have three attacks now?
I have one, two, three, four. Four if I use both hands.
You can't use your bonus actions. You need to actually be able to have a feat. Okay. For that. So two more strength checks.
All right.
Six will miss. One more. 14 will miss. So what is your strength? Zero?
Yes.
You deal 1 point of damage.
Yeah, I'm helping.
Freya.
Hello.
Hello, it's your turn.
It's my turn, yay! I will throw Sacred Flame at Red.
At Red, okay. It will nat 20 or go home. Alright, roll your damage. 14.
Pretty consistent with those 14s.
You are, definitely. You just need to get a max damage roll and go consistent. And then you'd be an all-star. Or a rock star.
Ba-dum-boom. Ba-dum-boom.
Kiki's standing Kiki. Between your legs, just tongue out.
Can I make a freebie Kiki throw?
I will let you, but it might engulf Kiki. Just want to tell you that.
Oh, well, it's not like Kiki's alive, but... No, yeah, that's fine.
Really
Kiki can
air.
Stay with me.
Yeah,
really Kiki doesn't, doesn't really need air.
Okay, that will take us to Pyra.
Pyra is going to raise her warhammer above her head and say, "Spirits of my ancestors, I call for your aid." She's going to pull for spirit guardians, and her spiritual weapon is going to strike at Orange also.
And we will see what happened. Courtney, thank you for the host. Alright, 15 feet. No, no. Roll me a spirit guardians first, just so I can make the wisdom saves. And sorry, we don't forget about them. Okay. Wisdom saves. Tenon and Ileana and Kaimal, I need wisdom saves from all three of you as well.
You cut out, so what'd you say?
I need wisdom saves from Tenon, Kaimal, and Ileana.
On it.
I'm gonna make one blankets for them. They'll all fail, so they'll all take 25.
Madfish is BRB right now.
Yep, so. I'll have him do it back.
Nice Kimmel, though.
You both will take 12 points of damage.
Oh, great.
If you need me to move your the thing so you can get your tokens, I can.
No, I just did it on my sheet.
Okay. And then you want to make that bonus attack for me? Back to work. The crit. Roll damage. 14.
You're not doing the drinking thing for the 24 hour?
Not right now. It's 11:40 in the morning. Otherwise, I would be drinking.
It's noon somewhere in the world.
It's almost noon where I'm in the world. Let me get past the first couple today. Like I said, I get up way too early. I'd like to make it through the 24. So, that is Pyrrha's turn. Ileana, you are blind, restrained, and you can't breathe.
I kind of want to attempt a dimension door out.
Okay, let me just want to double check something. Honor strain before I say yes.
Okay, no worries.
I want to say it will work.
I think it will, but...
Yeah, technically... You will lose your air. Because does Dimension Door have a robo component?
It has a V and a check mark with it.
Yeah, that's verbal. Alright, so where are you trying to Dimension Door to? You can't see it, so you're going to have to tell me distance without measuring. Direction and distance.
She would have gone 20 feet back.
20 feet north?
Yeah.
Okay, it is an actual open spot. You pop out there.
Sure. Ileana.
Yeah, it's like all the air force from your lungs. You're like taking a deep breath. That is your action.
Bonus to... Misty step here so I can stay out of range. Because I can still hit him back from back here.
You could have moved too. You didn't need to just
spell. Okay, well then I'll just move.
Okay. Alrighty. That will be the end of Ileana's turn. We'll go to Kaimul. You are at least awake.
There is that. I guess he will try and break the restraint. Thunder waving in this inside of something, probably not the best idea.
No, especially since you have no air in your lungs. Yeah, you do get out. As your action, you pop out.
So that's his action.
You're right there. Actually, sorry, you'd be right there. The way they're facing.
Ooh. I will. Do I have my dagger out?
Were your dagger? No, because your daggers weren't drawn when you were walking. You can pull your dagger out. It's a free action. You do wielder, right?
Yeah. He'll do that and he'll keep his Kimmel dagger in his offhand because I guess he has Howard out then already.
Well, he'd be pulling it out. Pulls that, pull it out, whatever one he wants in one hand.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, he'll do that.
Okay.
And I will reflect his actual health on his token now.
Tenon, are you there now? Fishy?
I am a stupid phone.
Fishy.
Yes, I'm.
Make me a wisdom saving throw, please.
Okay.
It happened when you were away, so.
Oh, okay. Watch out.
You'll take 12 damage. Kaimal, start your turn. And Ileana, I need wisdom saves from both of you as well. Okay. Your turn started. You were still in Spirit Guardians.
Okay.
Kimmel, you'll make it. You'll take another 12. Ileana, you'll make it. You'll take another 12. Okay. So, red's gonna step up 5. So is blue. I'm gonna make them a wisdom save. Reroll damage for me at this point, please.
Alrighty.
And I'll make a save. They'll fail.
22. Good damage. Is it radiant or necrotic?
Radiant.
What do they look like?
Firefly is all excited. She's like, someone outside my buddies. Yaha, at advantage, blue's gonna attack you twice.
Bring it on.
15 and 26.
One of those hit the 26.
Okay, take 15 bludgeoning.
Oh boy.
Red is gonna attack you twice at advantage. 23 and a 17.
Wait, you said red is attacking me at it?
Yep.
Could you repeat what the rolls were?
23 and 17.
23 and 17?
I bet.
One of those hit.
What's your AC?
It's 19 right now.
How?
Oh, wait, no, never mind. It's not a melee weapon. So, yeah, that hits. Never mind.
They both hit?
Yeah.
Take 21 more damage.
Oh boy, 21 more damage. A couple seconds, roll 20 is acting weird. Roll 20, come on.
I can take it off your tokens for you.
Thank you.
And you are engulfed by red.
Oh, I'm delicious.
Sefri. Blue moves up to Pyrrha. Taking Tenon with him. Sorry. For but a moment, you saw yourself, Tenon. Green's gonna attack Pyrrha twice.
Hi, Tenon.
20 and 24.
Both of them hit.
Alright, take 22 damage. I need 2 con saves, both are DC 10. So Spirit Guardians drops. On the first one. You don't have Warcaster. Wait, you don't have Warcaster.
I do.
You do?
I do.
Sorry. First time we've done con saves with you. On Pyrrha. And Pyrrha is engulfed.
Engulf something that's going to continue to hurt them.
Yep. And then... Arn's going to attack Kimble twice with advantage.
Okay.
Nat 20.
Oh, not
night. 20 on the first.
Yep.
And 22 on the second.
Down.
And engulfed.
Since I'm engulfed, do I feel lonely still?
Yes.
Aww.
That's not good. Tenon, I need a Constitution saving throw from you. Because you're inside of it. Yeah, you're fine. You don't take any damage. And you haven't gone unconscious, so you're holding your breath. Because you haven't screamed out. So, Tenon. You're inside this thing.
I'm gonna get out.
So, yep. Acrobatics or athletics, your choice. Just. Just gets up.
My bonus action. I'm gonna punch it, and I'm gonna use a key to hit it twice.
Okay, yep. Both will hit. For 15.
Okay. Okay, and it can make me. Let's see, where are we? I guess I can't. I guess I can't knock it prone or anything, can I? It's sort of a mound.
Yeah.
It will. Be stunned until my next turn. So, yeah, have it make me con save. Versus, what's his?
What's your plus to wisdom?
It's wisdom is 5.
5, and your proficiency bonus?
5.
So it's 18. If it's 5 and 5, it's 18.
Yeah.
It's a what kind of save? Dex? Con.
Con. Yeah.
It just makes
it. Oh, come on. That's why I never use that. They always pass. I've never succeeded at a stunning strike. It's so annoying.
Yeah, you're currently inside this thing.
Oh, boy. It's like an eternal hug, but it still doesn't satisfy my loneliness. Do I make a save or something?
If you want to try and get out of it. Okay, so try and punch it from inside if you want.
It's a strength save or a constitution save?
It's a escape DC, so you can either acrobatics or athletics.
Oh, acrobatics, okay. 19?
You'll get spit out.
Yay.
That's your action.
Oh, I can't disengage or anything. Okay.
Nope. So you that it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right, Freya.
Hi.
Hi.
There are people who are hurt.
There are people who are hurt.
Now, if so I turn to my divinity, am I? Yes.
You have to believe you have
am
to
I
see
actually
them.
Going? I do have to see them. Okay. I am actually still going to use my channel divinity and divide up those, now not 70 points. Now I actually have to figure out how much I do get.
75 if you're, it's a level higher.
You're level 15, right? It's 5 times your cleric level, so that's
70. Yes.
Yep, 75.
Okay, so 75 points that I will divide up between Ileana, Yaha, and Tenon.
25 each.
So, yeah, 25 each.
Thank you.
So, Sifri holds her holy symbol as this burst of radiant healing energy goes out, healing Ileana, Yaha, and Tenon for 25 points. And you see some of the wounds and the bruises start to heal on your skin. And that will take us to Pyrrha.
Yes.
You're inside this thing.
She is. And what would I have to roll to be able to break out? Acrobatics?
Athletics or acrobatics, your choice, when you're breaking the grapple.
I will go for athletics because it is her stronger suit.
Okay.
I hope it does something good.
Yeah, it's right out. I'm going to spit you out north.
And then her...
Technically there.
And then her spirit guardians will continue. We'll hit on their next turn.
Yeah, on the start of the turn, yeah.
And then her spirit weapon will attack Orange.
Okay.
And she will use War Cleric to hit green.
Can she do that? You have to do it on your when you make an attack.
Oh, when you make an attack roll, you can use it.
You use your action to get up, yep.
So just
the bonus on the spiritual weapon. Is all you can have left. That is a hit. For a 9. So again, this Aethereal Mace just slams down as into the back of it. That will take us to Ileana.
These things are probably flammable, aren't they?
You can give
it. It's still raining.
I mean, it's raining. But, I mean, you can find out. That's what you know. You can find out. No time like the present to experiment.
Yeah, but I...
You know there's no one in red, so, I mean, worst case scenario.
Okay. Then I'll firebolt red.
Okay. Alright, you hit it with the firebolt. Roll me damage. It doesn't do the damage you think it would. It does less. They are resistant to fire. Because they are like, all their bodies themselves are wet.
Oh, that's really smart.
Wait, if their bodies are wet, would that have, like, lessened my...
No.
Oh.
They're moist. They're more moss. Okay, Kimmel, before you make your death save, take a failure.
Mm-hmm.
And make your death save.
Sorry, you cut out. Was that take a failure and make a death save?
Correct.
Yeah.
So one success and one failure. Mm-hmm. At that, I need Pyrrha, I need you to reroll Spirit Guardians.
Alrighty.
For this turn.
And I take another failure?
No. You already took the one for Spirit Guardians. 17. They'll make their... You'll find out if you take more in a second. That being said, they'll make their wisdom save. They will nat 20, so they will take 8 each. 8. This one's still up because they passed. Alright. Kimmel, I think we'll do the most important thing in this on their turn first. Make me a constitution saving throw.
Me?
Yes, you.
Sorry.
You will not take damage from them. Okay. This one's going to move up here. With Kimmel inside it. It's already taking damage, so... Green is going to attempt to make us... Orange will attack you first, Pyrrha.
Already.
For a 10 and a 12.
19 gets above it. Yep.
So green will make its two attacks on you. For a 13 and a double nat 1, you know what? It kills itself. It's at 3 hit points. It commits. And that is 1. Okay. So that
its
one
is... Its arm, like, shatters as it hits Pyrrha's shield.
There you go. Blue tenant is going to make 2 attacks at you.
Okay.
At advantage. 24-23.
It's both hit.
So you will take another 25 damage.
Okay.
And you go back inside. As it moves up. I am so surprised that out of everyone, it's you that I'm consistently hitting. I really am shocked. I'm not going to lie. I was like, I swallowed 10 in once. That's cool. That's not going to happen again. So Red's going to attack Yaha. Twice.
I salute before it attacks me.
18 and a nat 20.
All right.
So 11, 21, 27 damage, Yaha.
Oh, boy. I'm one with you. Wait, no. That was wrong.
You got 27 off? Not yet. And Yaha goes back inside. That being said, that is the end of their turn. 10 at the start of your turn, I need a wisdom save first. DC's 15. Verse 17. It's either 17 or 8. Depending on if you pass the wisdom save, which I'm sure you will. So you'll take 8 damage. Do you want to break out again?
Yeah.
Okay. Make that. Don't worry about taking it off your token until you find out if you're out or not.
Okay.
Yep. Tenon squirts himself back out. Just pushes himself back out. He's like... he's thinking about going to the flowers to get the chill. again.
Wish stupid flowers work on these stupid things. Okay. And then I can still hit it with my... So I didn't take the damage, or...?
You do take 8. I just said instead of trying to do it on your sheet, where sometimes it gets messed up, okay. It's easier to do...
Okay. Alright, and then I am going to use... it was which one that swallowed me? Which one looks worse? Which one looks in worse shape?
The one to your right looks like it's taking more damage.
The red? Okay.
Yep.
I'm going to hit it with 2 unarmed strikes.
Sephiri, question for you.
What?
Yes?
Do you... you have Warcaster yet?
No, I don't.
So you do not have your weapon out. You need a free, or you don't have a, you have a shield, right?
I do have a shield, yes.
Okay, so they'll be evenly. However, I was just wondering because it mattered for the natural 20. They'll both hit, you just won't get the advantage. Because she doesn't have a melee weapon out.
Sorry?
They will both hit.
I'm not a threat. Not basically, advantage. I'm not a threat because I don't have a weapon out.
Oh.
So I can't give you the advantage.
That's why I ask her, because you're nat 20 on advantage.
So did the 16 hit?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Even the 15 hits.
Okay.
So.
All right.
It's 18. Yep.
And how does it look?
It's, you know, it's still up. It looks like it's parts of it are starting to come apart. You can probably see, like, a Yaha hand through. Previously, when it was swallowed, you couldn't see any of it. There's little kind of gaps kind of in its vines now.
Starts making gang signs with
hand out. I mean, you didn't really see the first one die, so it was hard to kind of gauge. Right?
Okay, why not? It doesn't cost me anything to try it again, so...
It'll cost a key point.
Well, it cost me a key to do the 2 hits.
And then it costs you a key for Stunning Strike. Stunning Strike is 1 key point. It doesn't get reactions either way. That's your normal monk ability. To stun it through the next turn is another key.
Oh, is an extra key. Okay, yes. For some reason...
Because that's what Jeremy was doing in the fight against Orcus. Spending all his key trying just to get the natural 1.
Yeah. Alright, so I won't do that. It'll just...
Alright, Yaha, you're swallowed.
Sorry. Never mind.
Okay. Yay for acrobatics. One more time? If I'm allowed to. Nat 20!
Yaha pops out right there.
Hi, guys!
That's your action.
Oh, okay.
You doing anything else?
Could I move? Or is that a part of my action?
You could move, but you'll take an attack of opportunity. Oh, you will not, because Tenon hit the one with martial attacks at red.
Oh, thank gosh. I'll go to where Ileana is, and I'll put my hands out and say, please, can you help me take these off?
So, that's her turn.
Yep.
I need a wisdom saving throw from you. Oh, no, you were not engulfed at the time. Spirit Guardians, never mind. I strike that. Sephiri.
Hi.
Hi.
I would like to Sacred Flame red, please.
Okay. Roll that damage. I mean, it's really tried, and it's done well. If it didn't have a -1, it would have negated 2 of them. I just want to point that out. I am proud of it nonetheless. It gets a gold star. So that is... Anything else, Freya?
I will actually bonus Mass Healing Word.
Okay. So you'll be able to hit everyone but Kimmel. Because everyone's currently out.
Yep.
So that is 15 healing to Pyrrha, Tenon, Yaha, and Ileana.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, sorry about that.
Yaha, did you put 15 points of healing onto your...
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I was working on it right now.
Okay, that will take us to Pyrrha.
Okay, how bad is Orange looking right now?
Not that bad.
Okay, she is going to go with Warhammer.
18 and 17 both hit. It's for 17.
And then she is also going to use War Cleric for an additional hit.
Okay.
Do you have this Dispelling Strike?
Not yet. She's at level 10. It's 11, right? So.
Yeah, because she's 5 and 5.
Oh, yeah, she's a mix.
Gotcha.
So, yeah, that last one misses.
Okay.
All right, and that's Pierre's turn. Ileana.
No, I don't suppose if I tried to hit Orange that it would help Kimmel get spud out.
Nothing has seemed, other than physically removing themselves, has seemed to do anything.
Then she's gonna Firebolt Red.
Okay. Natural 20 Firebolt Red, you mean?
Yes.
It actually catches a blaze and falls to the ground.
Good.
Okay. So, that takes... Anything else, Ileana?
As a bonus, can I try and help Yaha?
Nope, it's an action to make a strength check.
Okay. Then, she's good.
Alright, Kim, we'll take another death fail, and then roll me a death save.
Yep.
Kim expires.
Crap.
Reroll me Spirit Guardians, please. Team, and Tenon is just out of it, so Tenon doesn't have to worry about it this turn. They will not make it, they will take 18. Let's see. That's a free action. It spits Kimmel out and is going to make two attacks at Pyrrha for a 23 and a 10.
10 does not hit, 23 does.
9 in a con save. DC's 10. Yep, you'll be fine. Just take the 9. Blue's gonna go after Tenon. I mean, it's really, you know, it's really been tasting Tenon. However, not today. Not today. That is its turn, Tenon.
He is very upset at the sight of Kimmel. And he is going to eat this thing up.
Twenty-three hits. 16 hits. 20 hits.
See how
roll that damage first. 25 so far. And then the unarmed. 25. So 33. It's still standing.
Does it look like really, really hurt?
It doesn't look like you could kill it with one blow.
Okay.
Then I mean, it's really hurting, but it doesn't look like you could kill it with a single blow. Just guessing off your damage. That's why. Yeah.
It's not happy about Kimmel, but he doesn't want to walk into the Spirit Guardians because that would just be dumb. So he's gonna stay there and try and feed this thing up.
some more.
Okay. That'll take us to Yaha.
Could I use an action to try to get these bows off?
How are you going to do it? Both your hands are currently...
With my legs, then?
Okay, give me a strength check as you try and kick one off.
Strength save or strength check?
Check. Yeah, no. They did. You can't get your foot on it. It just keeps slipping off the crossbow.
Okay.
Anything else?
I don't think I could do much else. Wait, could I action surge and try it again?
Sure.
Okay. No, it just doesn't want me to fight.
That is Yaha's turn. Freya.
Hello.
Hello.
I would like to Sacred Flame Blue.
Okay. It will light on radiant fire and take 12 damage. It still stands. Looking really rough.
That's all I can do at this point. So it will be the end of my turn.
Okay. Pyrrha.
How bad is Orange looking now?
Rough. But it'll take a couple hits. At least one, two, maybe three. Depends on damage.
Is dropping Spirit Guardians a action or free action? Okay, she is going to go ahead and drop Spirit Guardians, calling out to Sefri, Kaimal needs help! And then she
He's
is going
dead.
To swing towards the shambling guy with her hammer.
Alright. Hit. For 20, still standing.
And she will use Divine Smite.
Okay. What level?
The first available one.
Yep, still standing. Anything else?
No.
Alright, Ileana.
She would like to Scorching Ray at
okay.
Third level.
Alrighty. 12 misses. 20 hits on blue, roaming damage. It will still be up. And your third ray going on blue again. Mm-hmm. Roaming damage. No, I don't think you kill blue.
I think because it was third level, she gets one more, which she'll put on okay. Orange.
Romy damage. Ileana kills Orange. And we are out of turn order.
He is gonna just run over to Kaimal.
Yeah, Sephiroth will run up to Kaimal, reach into her bag because she happens to have the spell components for Revivify.
Okay. Remind me, Huggles. You there?
Sorry?
Has Kimmel ever actually gone dead?
Nope. This None of my first... characters have.
It's 300 gold piece diamond, or am I taking...
Yep.
Yeah, because the diamond...
No, it's diamonds. So it's the plural.
Bag of diamonds worth 300 gold pieces.
So
I found it.
Yeah,
I was looking. I was just looking to see which one it was. Is this... let's see. Bag of diamonds worth 300. Archiving it as you're casting it. Okay, I need you to roll me a wisdom check. I keep forgetting that he didn't die. I when I'm thinking of Kimball going down, it's the not running and hitting the Titan landing on him, or whatever he rolled. I think he rolled a two.
Am I able to cast it's just a simple wisdom check. Not as, straight, okay.
No mod on it. Just wisdom.
I clicked it. Oh, there we go.
You watch as Sefri pulls the diamonds out, rushing up, putting them on Kaimo's chest. There's a quick flash of light as they just completely dissipate. And he just sits up.
Tenon gives
at
him
one
a
hit
break.
Point.
Just hugs him.
Dude. Careful when you hug him.
What are you doing? What happened?
Welcome back.
Why do I hurt so much?
Welcome back to the world of living.
Can somebody heal him a bit, please?
Yeah, I will channel divinity again. So that's my last channel divinity. So he will get a full 75 hit points back.
Oh, better. Thank you.
Oh, hey.
You can only heal the channel divinity up to half.
Half of their max level.
So, yeah, then get them up to half. The rest then will be distributed amongst.
He can take 46.
Okay. So.
Someone can take 29. You have 29 remaining, I should say.
Pyra's going to reach out to touch Kimmel's shoulder lightly, and wincing a little and going, sorry, and she's going to cast Cure Wounds at level 3.
You could divide the 29 as 14 and 15.
Okay, then Tenon will get 15.
Okay. Thank you.
Pyra will get 14.
Alright, and Kaimal gets
the 46, yeah. 46
plus
4
is
58. There should be
59
hit points.
Do you want a potion too? I have some potion. You will give Kaimal a greater healing potion.
I'm fine, I've got my own.
Take that.
He'll push it away and he's got his own.
Okay. Take that, then.
Oh, here's one of those. Nice.
I will also. Okay. Okay. All right. Well, that did not go well.
However, you do see a teabag on the ground.
Oh. Yeah. We found some tea.
Investigation to find some more?
Shh. I mean, it looks like it leads in the path that was highlighted for you.
Yeah. We should probably head down that path.
Looking at the time and seeing we have time for the final boss battle.
Alright.
Okay.
Let's
go. Anyone
have first aid?
I don't have it. I'm sorry.
Okay. Could anyone help me pull this off then? Because I
do
may
you
be
have
using
a
knife.
Melee weapon?
Yes, I have knives.
Okay, I will help pull off the crossbows?
You guys take, well, you take time out of combat. You can pull them out. Pull them off.
Okay. Do I get my channel divinities back?
You don't have time.
Are
for
we
going to
do a short rest? Okay.
All right. Everybody good? Everybody taken?
Ileana will cast Mage Armor on herself.
I'll do some hit dice.
Nope, no hit dice.
Oh, no hit dice, sorry.
Cast your Mage Armor, Ileana.
I'll use Second Wind then. So could I use Second Wind?
You can. You guys can come down to here.
Okay.
Okay.
Why is your Second Wind healed twice?
I don't know, I accidentally did that. Where did I get a plus 10? Oh yeah, that's my level.
Yeah, should be higher than level 10.
Oh crap, I haven't used this since I was level 10.
So as you guys come down here, we're gonna just have you right about there, right about here, Tenon, if you're on the front line. You kind of see, Tenon, give me a perception check, because you're leading up front at this point.
Okay.
You know, I mean, Kimmel normally out front, probably taking a step back right now after the close call.
Mm-hmm.
You notice in one of the trees that looked very similar to the one Yah had touched earlier, there's a skeleton that seems to be propped up by the sap.
Uh-oh. That's bad.
Is this poison to me?
There's a...
Which tree is it?
It's just one in. It's kind of in the woods.
Okay.
Bit. You just notice that.
I kind of have a feeling that maybe the trees are bad, and maybe the trees...
Is everything bad here?
Yeah, I'm kind of getting that feeling.
You hear a voice. Why are you in my forest?
We're just looking to help some people.
We came for a shipment of tea. Some merchants passed through, and we came to recover either them or the shipment they were carrying.
They ventured into my forest.
Oh.
You killed pets.
They attacked us.
Yeah. You should get a fence.
If you had your pets and you wanted them not to attack people, then you should maybe give them a collar, give them names, tell them not to attack random people. I realize that we're in your forest, but we did not know it was yours.
We're sorry.
Give you one chance to turn around and leave.
We have to help those people, though. Can we just take the stuff and the people and go?
They're mine. That they paid with their lives and their items.
See, the thing is, the people who really, really want their stuff back, and they're just gonna keep sending people.
Yeah.
Until they do.
And
so,
they'll keep killing them and taking their items.
Do you respect other people's lives?
Those who respect mine. And you just hear this whistle.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a surprise, because she called out.
Alright.
We'll roll the initiative to finish this off.
Has this been your forest for very long?
She just looks at you. You can't see her, but she looks at you. And it's been my forest since I moved here.
Do you mind if
I think we might have another princess. That was not all out.
Kimmel, your passive's pretty good. So you see this one here as it starts to move ready to get into the fight. You also see another one over here.
I would if roll 20 didn't decide to reload.
Yeah, my roll 20 just crashed. I'm trying to get back in again.
Okay.
Mine too.
Okay, Kimmy, you have one to your left, which is like 10 feet away, and then you spot another one on the other side of the three of you.
Hang on, I'm going to switch the
mic. It is like nothing has changed. At this point, you've also seen a couple of these things die, so I can do this.
Did somebody roll initiative for me?
Nope, I'll get it for you. And the roll 20 things begin.
Is anybody else having trouble with roll 20?
Nope, but I rolled a 17 minus 1 for your initiative.
I saw that. It seems to be loading good for me.
Yep, same here.
Okay, I'm actually going to do a complete reload, like a complete reboot of my computer. I'll be right back.
Okay. I'll stop play you for your turn. If you're not back.
Kim will, because I can kind of see it, but I think I need to reload. Kim's gonna... can I get to my sheet?
I got you.
Cool. Do you want to roll it, and then I'll just reload it? So Kim will go to the one to his left.
I opened Sindel instinctively. In a second. Hey, it happens, man.
Not quite the same.
Alright, so Kim goes to the one to his left.
Yeah, the one next to him.
Yep.
And he will booming blade, then Kimmel dagger. Alred, yeah. Kimmel dagger, and then move back just south of Sephiri.
So 20, 31, because you missed with the dagger.
You know my rule about... I have the same rule you have with Roland. He sneak attacks on his crit. Or on his bluff.
Yeah, you missed with the dagger, so I gave you sneak attack anyways, because I already rolled it. So. You get it. So you back up?
Cool.
You back up to protect Sephiri, or you back up?
I sit in the spot south, just below Sephiri.
Okay. Gotcha. Pyrrha.
Pyrrha is going to... I'm guessing she will try to guiding bolt the shambling mound.
Okay. Oh my god, it's an Ebby. 15 just hits. For 23.
And she is going to send her spiritual weapon up towards this guy up here, and she is going to take a swat at him.
Which will miss?
And that is it.
Caleb, are you back? Okay. So Freya will Sacred Flame, because no one's injured. Red, because Red's been taking the damage. And it will fail. It will take 13. And she will stay put. Yaha!
Yay, my turn. Yes, voice in the sky?
What are you doing?
Okay. So I pull out my daggers. Yes, I use those sometimes. And wait, is the area around the blue guy anyway concerning? Like, no skeletons stuck to trees or anything?
For the terms of this battle, no.
Okay. Then I walk up to him and...
And you die. No, I'm just kidding.
I get my jumbias and strike. Four.
Okay. Roll damage on all of them.
Yay.
Thirty-seven.
All right. And I think I'm done for now.
Okay. Tenon. The trees almost seem to part from your south. Like, they okay. just start moving. As you feel the ground shake, and something charges you.
Uh-oh. Oh no.
Well then.
That's bad.
Wish Bogle was here.
Dominate that beast.
And there will be a... I'm trying to think of this advantage. 29.
Yeah.
Hit 19, wow. So good thing it's not on that 20.
Mm-hmm.
It's 28 piercing. As these huge tusks get Tenon, he's like, ugh, I need a strength saving throw.
Okay.
You are not thrown prone. So okay. It does not get to stomp on your face.
Good.
That was her turn. It's now your turn, Tenon.
This damn thing hadn't attacked me. I was going to go for the Shambling Mound because I have advantage on it. Now I hit this thing.
You don't like my mammoth?
And then hit it again.
Oh, yeah.
And then hit it again.
Okay, let's put it this way. The only way you miss on Ives is by nat one-ing. You hit on all of those.
Alright.
It's got a 13 AC. So, what was I saying? 25, 29, 37, 46, 57 points of damage by Tenon.
Mm-hmm. And no reactions.
Yeah, it's a bestial creature. I'll say you can see this thing's health bar. Even though you've never fought a mammoth before, I would say... You'll be able to gauge it based on other beasts that you've probably fought before.
Okay,
that is Tenon's turn.
And he's like, don't get swallowed.
All the Ilianas.
As a free action, Ilianna's gonna look at the mammoth, which is probably a druid, and then look around for the other people who are probably druids in the trees. And she's going to ask them if they're with the Emerald Enclave.
There seems to almost be a angry sort of trumpet from the mammoth.
Newt, newt?
No. I said angry.
Oh.
Okay. So, they're not with the Enclave, but... Okay. She's going to... Firebolt the red Shambling Mound.
Okay. It hits. So, 11 damage.
That's right, because they're resistant.
Yep, I'll make you remember, don't you worry.
Thank you.
Anything else on your turn?
No, that's good. Welcome back, Kaylin.
Welcome
back.
I stat played Frey like a boss. She's Sacred Flame and something. That was before Jenny got cored. All right. Tenet, not to be undone, these bears come charging out at you.
And this oh, good.
Right there. Because bear. It's going to attack your advantage. It's going to first try and get him some button for 17.
Miss.
You get that. Have you ever seen a bear's trying to eat honey? You ever seen a video of it?
A what?
A bear trying to eat honey. They put the camera inside the hive. You get the big teeth like in your face, and the tongue's just licking at you. This
ew.
If this isn't an actual bear, this is probably a very young druid, because that was terrible. And then, you know, the claw. You get bear hugged, but not like strong. Just, you know, there's a slight caress. It reminds you of vampires. I don't know why. It just happens.
You getting out? Bye. Nope. Inappropriate.
And it's a new sitcom. Everyone loves Tenon. It's just everyone loves Ray, replaced with Tenon. Yeah. All right, Pyrrha. Red bear is gonna bite at you for a 21, and then the claws for a 24. He looked like he paid attention. He went to bear school.
Both of them hit?
24 damage in total. That one went to bear school. He graduated. He's proud of himself. Red Shelby Mound's going to come here and going to attack Kaimal at advantage, because advantage. 26 and 21. Gibble? The vampires were really into him, Nidar. That's still the first vampire one-shot. Not the second one where everyone died. But the first vampire one-shot, that was a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Kaimal.
The second one sucked.
It was a lot of fun.
I can't see my sheet, but the 26 and 21.
Your AC says 19.
I know. I will defensive duelist the first one. So I don't take it. My AC becomes like 23 for that hit.
You mean the second one? You do that too. Okay.
I thought you said 21 and 26.
26 and 21 respectively. So 26 was first.
Oh,
That's why I wanted to clarify so you could see it.
I meant the second one. Yeah. I can't stop.
I know that you can't see. That's why I wanted to double check. You did it in the first one. You would have wasted it.
I've got the map because I've got the Twitch stream up.
There you go. That's all you need. So, Yaha.
Yes, though.
13 and a nat 1.
13 and a nat 1. None of those hit.
Okay. Kaimal. Red's just come up to you. Oh. Hold on. Red's come up to you. Booming blade moving damage. 10 more. What would you like to do for Kaimal?
You still have advantage because of a guiding bolt. I believe. It would still be.
Yep.
It glows until Pyrrha's turn, I think, right?
Correct. First attack of Pyrrha's turn. You booming it? You booming blading it? I mean, I'm pretty sure she's booming it.
Does seem to be your MO.
I'm gonna go with it.
I know. Sorry, I muted myself. Two Aurids and a Kaimal.
No booming blade?
No booming. Straight ones, because otherwise I can't hit him three times.
Where is. I don't see regular Aurid.
There should be Aurid's short sword.
There it is.
Yeah, it's the money in the bottom.
And...
Nice!
I like to think that you, and then he stabs Freya. Good.
That's his advantage. Good.
He doesn't have it. He has advantage on the first strike. With
the first
hit? Oh, the first strike, yep. Yeah. First time he hit it.
Oh, okay. I thought it hit.
So, let's add this up.
I don't get my sneak attack either.
You do, you critted.
I'd have to use it on the first one.
Yeah, you would. So, let me change... Let me take out the 17 out of that. 28 damage to it. And then... Right. 8 damage to Freya. As Kimmel stabs Freya.
I can get my own...
Oh, I didn't realize you were back out of the way. I'm thinking you were the same as Huggles. Yeah. And you were having an actual connection... Like, not computers.
Oh, I was. No, but I'm totally back now.
Okay. Sorry, I didn't realize you were totally back. My bad. Pyrrha.
Pyrrha is going to rear back with her hammer, and she is going to smack for blue, and she's going to utilize Wrathful Smite.
Okay, it's a bonus action. First one hits. You don't. Do you get multi attack? Oh, from Paladin. Yep. So yep. Go ahead.
And then Wrathful Smite.
Okay, it's a Wisdom save. He is technically frightened. And damage on the second one.
Okay.
16 total. Alright, that is Pyrrha. Freya!
Hi.
Hello!
So I would actually like to pull out my longsword and take a smack at this shambling mound.
Okay.
And I will actually put Divine Strike on it as well, provided it hits.
No, and you are advantage, so that hits. So that is 12 damage. 12 damage.
And then as a bonus action, just quickly check my spell slots. Oh yeah, I'm good. I'm totally good. Okay, I will cast Healing Word on Pyrrha at 5th level.
Okay.
For 26.
Nice.
And I will get 7. So basically what Kimmel stabbed me for, I get most of it back.
Back, yeah. Sometimes you just gotta heal someone else to heal yourself.
And as a free action, she looks at Kimmel and goes, "Ow!"
Not very naughty, naughty man.
That so. Hurt, Kimmel.
All right, that will take us to Yaha.
Okay, so I'm gonna do my daily routine, except instead of crossbows, I'm using shanks. Okay, so I have a nat 1.
You do. I'm gonna say, okay, roll me damage on all but the nat 1. Nine, 18, 27, 4 is 31. It will take 31 and stab yourself with the nat 1 because I was going to have you lose your dagger, but I didn't feel like taking a nat 20 away from you.
So I stab myself?
Why, I know. Yeah, stab yourself for the nat 1.
8 poking damage, okay.
Alright. Hi, Devin.
Ow. This is why you don't run with knives.
Sorry, are you hitting me?
There's gonna be a stomp at you.
Okay.
An attempt to stomp you for 26.
Yep.
For 24.
Yeah, I'll take the damage off in one sec.
Sorry. I can't stop yawning right now. I'm in a yawning fit. Now will be your turn. Oh, a little, yeah. I gotta push through the first wall, Libby. And now it is Tenon's turn to beat on a mammoth.
Did I get,
No. No. You didn't. It can use it as a bonus action if it gores you, but it didn't leave threat to then charge you and try and do it. It just used that as its attack.
Alright. Well, what mammoth needs dying. So. Hit it.
The nat one.
Whoops! Sorry. I clicked the wrong thing. I don't have advantage on it, do I?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to hit myself or something?
No, because of your health, I'm going to say the second attack, you instead of getting the second attack off, you drop it, you pick it back up, you can make your marshals.
Okay.
I'm not going to have you hit yourself and potentially kill yourself. The 25 hits.
Yeah. And that was a pathetic amount of damage. And
is that really? I think
you can't do reactions.
No, that's 2 less than max for that hit.
It's good.
I mean, overall.
Yeah, overall. But I mean, you have it. See? Got the hat cap on. Alright, go ahead. Go ahead, Ileana.
As a free action, Ileana will suggest that, if possible, we not kill them and knock them out.
We need to put these guys down right now. Down, at least. Something, anything, because I'm going to die over here.
Oh, I know, I agree with you. I'm not saying that we don't need to. I'm just saying that there's an enclave that should deal with them afterwards. We can totally get them down.
Agreed.
She's going to haste you.
What's her response? Ileana, you're a wizard, right? You can't twin spell, right? You can't twin spell?
Unfortunately, I don't think.
I was thinking you were a sorcerer. I was trying to remind you of the ability that you don't have, Ileana. Mm-hmm. Alright, so Tenon gets the effects of haste. Tenon begins to go fast.
Tenon goes fast. Hopefully, he will not get staggered.
Well, there's nothing really immediately threatening, Ileana, so.
Yeah, I mean, she can move back one. I found a log.
Inside the log is Excalibur. No.
Cool.
Alright, that'll take us to the druids. Blue's definitely going to attack you, Tenon, because it's currently afraid of Pyrrha. So, Blue Cave Bear...
You cut out on what you were saying.
It's going to attack... Blue Cave Bear is attacking Tenon because it's afraid of Pyrrha.
Yep.
So 22 and a 26.
26 hits.
Take 13. And then Red Cave Bear on Pyrrha. For a natural 20 and a 25.
Both hit.
So 14, 25. That is the end of the druid's turn. Shambling Mound is going to go after Kimmel. At advantage. 16 and 20. No.
That's on.
Next makeshifter. Does a 20 hit? Or are you reactioning?
Our reaction. What was the first one? Was it 2?
No, you would only 16 was the first at advantage.
Okay. Do you know what? Because I am next to the other things as well. I will.
They already went.
Oh, they then I will defensive duelist.
Yeah, I'm trying to help you. That will take us to blue on Yaha. So an 18 and a natural 1.
None of those hit.
It would have thrown your dagger back at you. An 18. Okay. That is the Shambling Mound's turn. We will then go to Kimmel.
I will make with the stabbings of the Owlreds and the Kimmel dagger. So 2 Owlreds and 1 Kimmel.
2 Owlreds and 1
Kimmel. Actually, no. First he'll move round.
You have so advantage right now.
Oh yeah, because you just got sword out. That's fine. Then he'll stay there.
That's a natural 20.
No, he will still move. Still snake.
A second natural 20, because I'm rolling for you.
Nice.
And then a 16, which still hits.
I'm really sorry about the stabbing you before, but stab.
Yeah, he doesn't say sorry, he just emo flips the hair.
If you're going to make with the stabby, you make sure that you stab the enemies and not your healer.
I'm a little out of sorts.
58 damage. Okay, let's do this. So you stab that one on the first natural 20, and you kill it, because you could. That takes us to there. The second one was 17, so 27. You put on the bear without having to move. Boom. Done. Kimmel looks like a badass. For once.
I know.
Good job, Kimmel.
Well, we'll take us to Pyrrha.
Pyrrha is going to use her hammer against Red twice. And she is going to utilize Thunderous Smite. She's going to do that.
Okay.
Warhammer.
Okay. Peppers, I got a question for you. Why is your AC above... Well, I get that it's an 18 right now. Because you have melee weapons out, but how is it a 19? Both of those hit, by the way. And you're attacking the blue or the red one?
I'll go for the blue.
24. Okay, barely alive. And a strength save. Which it makes. Anything else, Pyrrha?
I think that's all that I can do, because the smite is a bonus action.
Smite's a free action. You can smite on every attack if you want.
Okay, then can I use my spiritual weapon? No.
Thunderous Smite's a bonus action. I thought you meant just Divine Smite. That was my mistake. No. My misunderstanding.
Oh, come on.
That will take us to Sefri. Hello, kitten.
Hello. There are some folks who need with the healing.
There is some folks that need with the healings. All the healings.
I will cast Mass Healing Word at 4th level.
Okay. Roll the heals. So that is 15 healing to everybody. It's homebrew in the game setting. Not most of the stuff that we do.
That is my bonus action.
That is your bonus action.
That is my bonus action.
Would you like
as
to
my
pet
action.
A kitten? As an action, would you like to pet a kitten?
I would.
Come here, kitten.
Kitone.
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 I'm not playing fetch right now. Sorry. I'm beating up the players.
I will... Unfortunately, I am going to have to kill Steel.
Oh no.
So I will zip down here.
Don't. Please don't take away this imminent threat from me.
I'm gonna laugh if she misses now because she was trying to kill Steel.
Yeah.
I'm gonna so laugh.
Actually. And look at that! I miss!
Why did you have to curse us then?
So. Anything else you'd like to do? Well,
nope,
Kitten comes to say hi.
That's hello, Kitten. That's my action. That's my bonus action. That's my movement. And she's going to be like, you guys got this.
Have you seen my shiny new sword?
Yeah. What is that?
Oh, Sparks is so mad. He just logged in to see the mammoth. Your turn. You have 4 minutes to defeat all the enemies, or you all die. Because my pizza will be ready.
Do I have all my daggers? Sorry.
Yes, because that's why you stabbed yourself.
Oh, okay, just making sure. Okay. CQC.
Miss. Hit. Crit. Crit.
Well then. Wait, you said miss on the first one?
First one missed, second one hit. So the two crits.
Okay.
And your armor class, by the way, is also only an 18 when you're with
me. It's also what?
Only an 18, not a 19.
Wait, I'm wearing studded leather, and I have,
yeah, and you
two
have
melee
five.
Weapons.
Yeah, 18, not 19.
Oh, okay.
So you also take a free slam attack next round, since I rolled
okay.
an 18. So that's 12, 14, and that brings it 21. 24 points of damage. By Yaha, she slashes into this shambling mound of vines.
Mm.
So,
does it smell like cucumber?
The mammoth will... No. The mammoth will bring down its great stomp upon Tenon, or attempt to at advantage. 22 will miss. Because he has haste.
Well. Yep.
Okay. That brings us to Tenon. Now with haste.
Who's very... Do I hit it? Or do I heal myself? You know what? I trust my healers will help me. And I'm gonna have some faith.
You gonna have a little bit of faith?
I'm gonna...
Praise
you know
Angerad!
I'm gonna start with the blue bear. I'm gonna hit it once with the staff and see if it knocks it down.
14 will do this to it.
I would have advantage because it's
29 because Freya's right there.
And Pyrrha's right there.
Yeah. Okay.
Revealing a druid.
And the rest. Yeah. And he's gonna glare at the druid.
Who glares back at you? That was my only wild shape!
Gives him the finger.
You look very pretty this way.
And then I'm gonna hit the mammoth. Because it's pissing me off.
Yes. With a nat 20, he will hit the mammoth. And don't forget, you have another staff attack. Because you are hasted.
I have which?
Another staff attack, because you are hasted.
Oh, that's right. So it's indeed. Staff. We get another staff
which will hit
attack.
For 14.
And then it will take an unarmed strike.
Yep.
And you know what? Take another unarmed strike.
The 12 miss, however.
So that was a waste of key.
That wouldn't have been a waste if you hit.
No. Stupid dice.
Stupid dice, being all... yeah, this map was actually made by Madfish, because I was
it
running...
It was.
super easy. And I was like, ah, I'm going to throw this here and that there and done.
I made the map. I made the map.
There was no enemies, no story. It was a map, and it worked perfectly. Because I just threw enemies on the side and goes, one of these storylines will work. Let's see what we get. So we had this one. So, Tenon, that is your turn.
Yeah.
Ileana.
Ileana. She's gonna Eldritch Blast the Shambling Mound.
How many blasts do you have at this level? I'm just curious.
Three.
Okay. Roll away. 23 hits. 27's hit. 15 meets. So you hit. 14. 13. 10. You know, that's 37 points of damage. Ileana just throwing these beams of force. Or have you spent enough time, or Michael, where you're starting to do finger bangs now? Or Veil?
Oh, yeah.
Just pow, pow, pow! As these three beams of force hit this thing. And it glares. So, end of your turn?
As a free action, she'll ask the druid, can we please stop with the fighting?
If you run away, he shouts back at you.
Like,
I'm gonna take you to the Enclave.
Yeah, you will. And that's the end of your turn.
Yeah.
In the beginning of your turn.
Yeah, I will.
Okay. He's going to. So the blue ones would be like, oh, you get a quarterstaff? I have a quarterstaff. And he's going to miss you.
Miss. And Tenon's going to be like, eat a bowl of dicks. Because he's really unhappy at this moment.
Is he, though? I mean, is he really unhappy?
Yes.
That's fine. The cave bear, which is still a cave bear, is going to go, and go White Claw on Pyrrha for revenge on both. 26 and 25 both hit.
Yep.
For 15. It's all roar. That will take us to Druids. The cat just attacked my feet. And the Shambling Mound is going to now.
Darn, that Druid's this. Really good at their job.
Gonna hit Yaha.
Oh boy.
24.
Definitely.
18.
Yep.
And the extra one's just so I click three times.
Okay.
So you're going to take, let's see, that's 30... 43 points of damage, Yaha.
Oh, boy! Okay! You said 43.
Yeah, 43.
Holy crap! Wait, what? That's not what I meant to do.
Did you... Minus 43.
There we go. That's
and
what I meant
engulfed.
To do. I'm delicious.
And then it's gonna It's just gonna come right over here with Yaha. Kill.
Would that have ended up bringing forward opportunity from the spirit weapon?
Spirit weapons don't get opportunities.
Okay, I was just asking. I haven't been able to play with spirit weapons too much.
I wish they did. That'd be amazing.
Oh, the drawing tablets? Yeah, those are free. So. Kimmel, are you going to attack the cave bear?
Yes, I am. What? And guess what?
What? You're going to tell me you can roll? Oh my god, I'm so proud of you. So why don't we do this one by one, okay? So do the first one. 9. Do the second one. So this guy reverts and he takes 6 damage in his form. You don't get XP for the bears. Sorry. He takes 6. 6 damage. You step up, and I take it that you then drive home the sneak attack and the dagger?
Uh-huh.
So that's 12.
It's around here somewhere. The silver, the snake.
So 12, yeah. So that happens.
If he thought he would go down, he would have done it, like, back of the blade.
You probably didn't think it was going to go down.
Yeah.
Like, you know, they've taken a couple hits. Shink!
Oh.
Pull it out. There's that squirt of, like, arterial blood, like, in Kimmel's face. You're like, oh. Then just steps up.
Uh-huh. He will probably step up here next to Tenon. They're not so hot.
Pyrrha.
Okay, Pyrrha is going to one swing of her hammer for Shambling Mound first.
Hits. Still up.
Okay, she is going to give him a second attack.
Miss.
And then she is going to bring her hammer down, the spirit weapon, and she is going to try to smack him with that.
Alright. Why are you killing all Spartans? Why are you killing all my true friends? That's a crit.
They're not friends. As Slade says, they're dirty druids.
How dare you! So, that is 6. He is still up.
That's all that Pyra's got for this turn.
All right, Freya.
Hello.
Hello, Freya.
How's it going?
Good, we're running a bit long. But we're good.
Sorry.
We'll make it up. Honestly, I'm just Eldrani, can't play later. It's fine.
I will move up to where Blue is.
Okay.
I'll move up so I'm right behind Pyrrha.
Okay.
I would like to smack at it with my longsword.
Would you like to attempt the kill steal?
Yes. Yes, I would.
I've got this, though.
That is a hit for 22. So four.
I will also put Divine Strike on this.
Put that Divine Stank on it.
Yes.
12. You successfully kill steal as it crumbles on top of Yaha, killing her permanently.
You do not know how horrible
really?
That felt.
No.
Oh, jeez. Don't do that to me.
Yaha, on your turn, you can spend all your movement climbing out and standing up.
Oh, great. Yeah, okay, so...
As a bonus action...
I'm just saying on her turn.
Oh, okay.
As a bonus action, what would you like to do?
As a bonus action, I would like to do Healing Word at 3rd level.
Okay.
So both, so actually everybody gets 14 healing.
Nice healing word. 14 to healing to everyone.
Sweet.
Thank you. Oh, you said everyone gets 15?
Yes, everyone gets 15.
14.
Sorry, 14. My bad.
Oh, great.
Who's eating crisps?
Sorry, I thought I'd missed it. I need chocolate.
Oh, it's my go.
You can only have some if you bought for everybody.
You climb here.
Yeah.
So you climb out, you stand up, you have no movement left.
Okay. Is it possible for me to throw my dagger at the mammoth?
No, they're bound to your hands currently.
Mm-hmm. I asked someone to throw me at it.
So Yaha's like, why won't they go? Shaking her hands violently. That is her turn.
I can see it.
So the mammoth backs up and looks at Tenon. Would you like to take an attack of opportunity, Tenon?
Yeah.
Please make your attack of opportunity.
Okay. Come on.
That is it. .422. It's gonna charge at you.
Okay.
So attack at advantage.
Mm-hmm.
With the gore for 27.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay. So you'll take 29 piercing.
Ow.
And then you'll make a strength save.
Okay.
You will go prone. The DC is 18. It will then use its bonus action to stomp down on you.
Okay.
At advantage. 28.
Yep.
For 32 more damage. Just boom! Is he still up? I just looked. And then he's getting just enough to. Just enough movement to kind of get out of range.
Actually,
you already use your reaction.
I am going to use my action, spend a. I guess I'm gonna have to because I am really hurt, and it's gonna be a bit before I can get healed. So. This heal.
Yeah, we use it for the overall continent and world maps make the incarnate, as Spartans is telling you. I just know, like, I looked at it, I'm like, oh.
Oh, sorry, that should be 42.
Yeah, because you just leveled up.
Yeah. So that's my action, and then I have the athlete feet, so it only takes me 5 feet of movement to get up. Not like it's far away anyway. Step up to it. And I am a little upset. And I'm gonna hit it.
You do hit it? Still up? Much...
Does it look like I could do some damage if I hit it again?
I mean, you can definitely do some damage. You do hit it again. So
another
11. So minus... Okay, so this mammoth goes...
Good.
And that appears. And she needs to take...
And she sucks. And I tell her that.
She laughs at you. Give me a perception check, Tenon.
I just forgot. I have haste. I still have one
action.
Get a action. Yeah. Okay. Sorry. Perception check.
Your movement also increases.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, good.
Nope.
Yeah, I don't notice anything.
Nope. Just right, run right at her.
Yeah, because
nothing bad will happen.
Nothing bad will happen.
Okay.
Nothing bad will happen.
No, nothing bad did happen.
Okay.
Just a hit.
Is that hit?
So, 15. Alright, turn?
Yep. Also, ow!
Alright, Ileana!
Hi!
Hello!
She's gonna... Say hi to the druid, and she's gonna ask it its name and all the other druids' names.
Just laughs, don't you?
Oh. Well, that's not nice. I have a question. Can magic be used non-lethally?
No. That's unless it's non-lethal magic.
Well, she's gonna Eldritch Blast this one.
Okay.
They probably both still have a lot of hit points. We're just knocking down some wild shapes. So.
Those will all just hit. 10. 9. 8. Yes! I called her right. So 17. 27 points of damage from Ileana. And then it is the druid's turn. He looks, and he goes, screw it. Constitution saves from all of you standing together.
Oh boy.
Pushed 10, so boom.
Liberated, hopefully.
You'll take 21, Sephiroth. Sephiroth and Yaha take 10 each. And Kimmel, you back in to do the thing. 4 damage of magic. Maybe, yeah, it depends on the spell. Kimmel will still pass because it's a 12 DC. And take 10 damage. So, there is no Shambling Mounds, but there is a Kimmel. So what are you doing, Huggles?
What is the... Which druid is it that did the... Oh, blue.
Blue, okay, yeah.
Got it. Never mind.
Come on, we'll unmute himself.
He will unmute himself.
That's my trick. And I'm going to... Oh, I actually didn't mean to throw that. I meant to throw the booming.
All right, just reroll the booming.
Booming, red.
Hit.
Black blade of Kimmel dagger. So, all of that. He gets that.
He's already down.
Oh. Well, that was a waste of a booming.
The thunder just, like, cracked his skull. So.
Then Kimmel is gonna come up here. Let me this side.
Okay.
Yeah, he can do that. And that's his go.
Okay. So that takes us to Pyrrha.
Pyrrha is going to advance down towards.
Okay.
He is going.
You won't get all the way down there. You were prone, so half your movement's standing up.
Okay.
Unless you're going to double move.
No, she won't double move. She'll get as close as she can. So. Here.
Okay.
And then she will use. Sacred Flame. Now she'll use Guiding Bolt on it.
Okay, roll me a Guiding Bolt attack. That will crit. Just make sure you're counting up the...
I'm counting all my spells as I'm doing it.
Well, no, telling me what level you're casting spells at before you cast them.
Okay.
It just stops someone from going, oh yeah, that natural 20, I rolled the level 9 spell. Guiding Bolt. Like, you know, I mean, people tend to do it. It's just, it's a habit. That is 35 damage. Okay, minus 35. Alright. Sephiri.
Hi.
Because Pyrrha's maul's out of range.
I'm gonna come up and touch Tannen. And give him the words of encouragement.
He has a wife.
How dare you touch him that way?
I am going to.
Jeez, everyone keeps touching each other's fingers.
Hey.
I will. Not healing word, but I will cure wounds at third level.
Okay.
Sephiroth's hugs are very chaste.
They are indeed very chaste. She comes up and basically touches his shoulder and is like, you can have 18 points of healing back.
Does she actually say 18 points of healing?
No, she basically says, you know, may the power of Ilmater help you endure.
with 18 points of healing.
As a bonus action, I will healing word. I will healing word Pyrrha. And I will do so at second level. So Pyrrha gets 15 back. And now I am back to full hit points. And she'll wave at the druid and go, hello!
Just looks at you, oddly. Yeah.
Okay, so I run over to the druid and I say, how do these work, as I try to slash at her with my knives, this time non-lethal damage, if I do anything.
You're gonna slash at her non-lethally with your knives, okay. You're dealing with non-lethal slashing damage, understood.
Just in case.
Also known as blunt damage.
You don't hit the arteries.
Those will all hit.
Okay, one more. All of them? All four? Yeah. Alright.
You rolled above a 20 on a druid.
Okay.
14 and 12 is 26. Okay. So, every single one of you, make me a dexterity save. Except for Ileana, because you're way too far away.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
I will get her DC for you in a second.
Holy crap! She nat 20'd! Nice, Ivory!
So, Yaha, Kimmel, you'll take none. Tenon, you'll take half because of evasion. Sephri, you'll take half because you passed. Pyrrha, you're taking all of it.
That Kimmel doesn't have evasion yet.
Oh, so you'll take half then.
Yeah.
Be right back.
And those corpses that you tried to take, they're all gone as she calls down columns of fire in a firestorm, letting the forest on fire.
And I am down. By 1 point, I was down.
She will then step away.
Twice, attack opportunity?
So, yep. Send in Yaha and Kimmel again.
Okay, so wait, sorry. Yeah. Half 37 is 17?
Yes.
Oh, 17. Okay, I'm taking no. 7.
Oh, wait. 18. Am I taking... Oh, you're I'm not taking 18. 37, I'm only no, taking 18. Half.
Yes, you actually pass the deck save. That's what happens.
Alright, so attack of opportunity.
Yep.
And this is out of 10, so I can sneak on it, right?
Yep. Not gonna matter.
I can't cantrip.
No, you cannot. Unless you have the whatever it is. Is it Warcaster?
Yeah, Warcaster allows you to cast a spell. 20. If the zoom hits.
It does. Roll me damage, Peppers.
Okay. 8.
Not enough, as she then uses her bonus action to shapeshift into a giant eagle and fly away.
Damn it.
I scream out, I wish I had my crossbows.
How far away?
You won't be able to see her through the fire and smoke that is engulfing. You're too far away to try and get the shot now.
You know, I feel was intended for druids.
All of the bodies that you guys tried to capture were incinerated. And we close. However, because you guys attempted to capture them, she could not burn the tea.
Yay!
So, you guys end up going... I was surprised. Wait, what? Kill the damn druid! You guys end up getting the tea. You guys don't find any of the effects, but you guys take note of the location to pass on to probably some of the druids.
Oh yes, definitely.
That may be relatively interested in what has happened here, because you guys missed some other fun some other fun flowers and other plant life that was here. Cause... Okay,
you'll just get to use them in something else.
Oh, don't worry. I have plenty.
Tana, could I sniff some of the flowers?
No.
Okay.
Oh, actually, no, I won't.
Anyone gonna pick Pyrrha up?
Yeah, well,
of course.
I can get you up. Hold on.
I don't need any turn. I was just asking. I need. I say
there.
Okay. I've had. Let's see. Yaha's hands are stuck. So you know what? I'm gonna say Fallen. Roll me a D100 as you guys search the last log.
A D100.
Yep. As you find some group loot.
I will actually use my healer feat to get Pyrrha back on her feet because I can.
Let's see, it's that or... You guys find a pair of etched bracers.
For...
Yep, you find a pair
like
of etched
arrow
bracers.
Bracers?
You don't know, they're etched.
Alien, they will do arcana?
Like arrow bracers? Or...
Give me an arcana.
Do they look like the ones I'm wearing?
They do not. Eliana, you've seen these before. So the DC was easier. But you crush it.
Okay.
Like normal. You found a pair of braces of archery. They require attunement. They are +2 damage to range attacks.
Oh!
You've seen them because Misty wears them.
Yeah.
Also, the general ground around you guys is on fire. So, as you guys discuss, and you'll go back, you'll get your money. We said, what, 1,200? Is that what we had?
It was 1,500,
yeah.
I believe. I'll
look at notes. Look at your notes. That will go on sheets. I need to run down and get the pizza that was ready 30 minutes ago. That I'd ordered this morning. It's a taco pizza. It's amazing.
That is 1,200.
That sounds delicious.
1,200. I will back in a few. We'll pick up with the next one shot. And okay. You guys figure out who's taking that loot. Epi, are you in as a DM currently or no?
No.
I said currently. All right, I will hand them out whenever they get back. So,
I think Eliana should get the bracers. Eliana definitely should get the bracers.
I get food, and then we'll be back with some more on the 24-hour stream.